Com.
The headlines have hit the news, claiming shortages of vehicles in Middle Tennessee, not at Music City Autoplex. Their exceptional wholesale buying ability has allowed them to increase inventory to meet your needs like no other dealership. More late model, low mileage choices, more financing options, more SUVs, more trucks, more sedans. So visit Music City Autoplex today and find more of what you want in a vehicle purchase experience. See why Music City Autoplex is growing and why they are the uncommon dealership. Located at 2430 Gallatin Pike or online at MusicCityAutoplex.com.
Do you need organization in your home? I did, in my garage, and I got it. Thanks to Artisan Custom Closets, not only is it functional, but it's beautiful, and now everything has a place. Took less than a day to install, and they worked with me to make sure that everything I put in my garage was in my budget. Maybe it's your closet that needs some love, or your pantry, mudroom, home office, you name it. Artisan Custom Closets can do it. Call them at 615-800-2199. Visit artisancustomclosets.com. If you're thinking about selling your home this spring, now is the time. Hey, this is Dawn Davenport from 3HL. And when it comes to selling your home, experience matters. The Wall Street Journal ranked Mark Spain Real Estate number one in the U.S. for closed transactions for the third year in a row. So if you need to sell your home, they can help you today. And when you call them, they respond fast. 855-299-SOLD is the number. Sell your home hassle-free and skip the constant cleaning, repairs, and all the stress that goes with it. The guaranteed offer from Mark Spain Real Estate gives you an opportunity to receive an all-cash offer and close in as little as 21 days, and their offers are the strongest in the industry. They've been in the business for over 25 years. Trust me, they've served over 25,000 families. They know what matters most: a quick sale, maximum profit, no showings, no open houses, no stress. It's simple. Go to markspain.com to get a guaranteed offer on your home today. Markspain.com and start packing.
Mix a little sports analysis, pop culture, and great interviews, and you've got the Rich Eisen Show podcast.
Joe Manganiello.
The Snyder Cut.
What was that like for somebody who was actually in it?
Well, I'm really happy for Zach.
How's Bubbles the dog?
Bubbles is on my lap right now. She doesn't really like it when I'm on the phone. She wants me to get off and pay attention to her.
Well, she's literally what?
She's 4.8.
So she got fat in the pandemic, is what you're saying.
Yeah.
The Rich Eisen Show podcast. Listen on Apple Podcasts or wherever you get your shows.
From the Mark Spain Real Estate Studios, this is your Titans NFL Draft Station. WGFX Gallatin Nashville. Trending now at 104.5 The Zone.
Good afternoon, I'm Will Bowling. John Fulkerson is back. He announced on his Twitter account today the forward will return for his sixth season of eligibility under Rick Barnes for the Tennessee Vols. Former Tennessee Lady Vol Renia Davis was taken ninth overall in the WNBA draft last night by the Minnesota Lynx. She finished her Tennessee career as the ninth leading scorer in program history. Braves outscored the Marlins 7-6 yesterday, and so far this afternoon, they're up 4-1 in Wrigley. And in Knoxville, a big series on the diamond between second-ranked Vanderbilt and third-ranked Tennessee. That'll start this evening. Breaking news at once on your home for the Titans and Vols. This is 104.5 The Zone.
The 3HL with Brent Doherty and Dawn Davenport.
HL 104.5 The Zone, Brent Doherty, Dawn Davenport out today. She went to the Auburn spring game. Not like as a fan, like a super fan that has to go to the spring game. She's working it on the sideline. I guess ESPN. Ron Slay in the mix today.
I'm in the building.
I really thought we'd have you a key card by now.
I know, man. I got to keep – I told Buck, I'm just going to keep on scaling the wall because this must be part of the training program. You know, when the guy's trying to get involved, you know, I keep scaling the wall, show my athleticism and what I can bring to the company. If you give me three steps, I'm making clear in one swoop. But for now, you know, right now, until I lose about 15 more pounds, I got to do the old school, put your leg up, then try to get over and don't get stuck.
I was going to say, like, you do that one time or can you do it repeatedly? Like, I mean, is there a consistency level here to this workout?
This is a one-time show, baby.
Okay, so you played 14 years overseas. Did you just cut it off immediately in terms of working out, or did you try to stay in shape after that was over?
No, I stay in shape. I stayed in shape for quite a while. This was the first
I'm
year,
not
actually.
Saying you're not in shape. Yeah, I just realized
like
now
was
I'm freezing.
You stabbing me a little bit, right? I think you were coming at me a little bit, right?
I have been.
But in the summer, I'm ready. Like, I am. It's time for me to now start ramping it back up because guys are about to start coming home from overseas that we train with, Skill Wing, and we get active, and I'm one of the guys that got to get out there.
So if I can't be out there, as you work guys out, you work out with them.
Yeah, I got to play. Yeah, okay. I can't. It's better if I show you. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's a lot of guys. Like, what's the guy's name? I forgot for the Lakers. Old, gray hair and everything.
Eldon Handy. Campbell.
No, something like him, though. I think his name is Handy or something, but if you look at him in the drills, he shows LeBron and them exactly what to do, and the dude got to be 65 with handles. I'm talking about handles.
Gary
so
Payton.
I'm going to be that guy. Yeah, I'm going to be that guy. I'm going to be that 65-year-old out there talking trash, you know, like we were just talking about out there. Get that out of here.
Get it out of here. Yeah, my 14-year-old played AAU basketball, his first tournament last weekend, and there was a shot right in front of my wife. My wife was sitting there, and right before the half, and this guy goes up to block the shot. Before he even blocks the shot, he's like, get that S out of here, boy. And my wife's like, oh, my.
Hey, and guess what, though, Brent? For people wondering, like, if you follow me on Instagram or, like, during the summer, I post the post-workout. So I'm still talking trash and everything. Like, I got a couple on them. Sometimes I get a little out of hand. Like,
well, and I told him because he said, Mom, that's going on the whole game. Yeah. Like, that's just the way it is. And I said, look, I don't want you to do it unless you're having fun with it.
Right.
And I was immediately thinking of you.
Yeah.
Because, like, you had fun with it.
That's
like,
it,
because
man.
You had fun playing the game.
That's it. You got to have fun. If you're not having fun, man, all of it's a part of it. And it's got to be – you got to be trying to do it for a reason. Like, when I continued to keep talking trash, it was to get into the opponent's head. Like, especially going into college, I'm going to be playing probably 16 minutes a game.
Yeah.
You got to deal with me these 16 minutes. And if I can distract you from doing your job, I won.
And that's the funny thing about this whole Trevor Lawrence thing with
right.
The quotes coming out about him. And Ron, I want to get your take on this. We talked a little bit about it yesterday. But the thing about it for me, I've talked to so many people in the NFL world about stuff like this.
Mm-hmm.
And – like, one thing that sticks out to me, when Matt Leinart went back to school for his senior season, there were people around the league that were like, he don't want it.
Right.
Like, that. So that was the knock on him, that he don't want it. And so you're going to go first round or what, you know, it just takes one, that kind of thing. But the word around the league, once that dude decided to go back,
mm-hmm.
the knock on him was, and it. I know it's not specific, like Peyton Manning came back too, and he was fine, but – the knock on him suddenly was he doesn't want it. So then, you know, you get these Trevor Lawrence quotes and quotes about him to Sports Illustrated. I think that's unhealthy, Trevor Lawrence said, just always thinking that you've got to prove somebody wrong. You've got to do more. You've got to be better. Which stuck out to me because, honestly, and I've said it on the show, that's what drives me.
Right.
I had a program director tell me I would never be on the air. So my whole career, like almost every day, I think about that.
Right.
Hey. And like, how can I get better? And I think about that. And so that quote was weird to me. And I knew that I didn't know what the public reaction would be because he's like the golden child,
mm-hmm.
and he can't do anything wrong, that kind mm-hmm. of thing. But I knew I know people around the league were like, okay,
yeah,
all right,
duly noted. Like that's
we
a
can
guy.
Get to you.
Yeah, that is a guy that you know. I don't want in my program. If I have a pick. And I can pick a guy that I know is going to go all balls out to the wall and go get it every time. And he has something to prove, play with a chip on his shoulder. Give me that guy, even if he's less talented, because lo and behold, something happens. He gets injured or something. I don't worry about him doing his rehab and trying to get back and knock it out and come and show who he is. This guy is more talented and doesn't really want it. He gets hurt, and we invest all this money and future into him. He's not going to give it to you. Well, this guy, it doesn't mean as much to him, apparently.
So his dad said this to Sports Illustrated. He's not, I want to win a Super Bowl at all costs.
Tuh.
I'm like, man.
What are we in the business of?
What are we doing?
Exactly.
So then his high school coach said he could walk away from it tomorrow and be fine, which – that's great. I know a lot of people that think, and this is a healthy way to think, I'm not defined by
true.
What I do.
Mm-hmm.
But if, like, I love my job so much that I said this yesterday. I had a non-compete situation where I couldn't do it for a certain amount of time.
Yeah.
And so I went and sold cars. I went and sold printing. I had to make ends meet. I can't just sit out. But I missed the creative day-to-day that this job offers.
Mm-hmm.
And the second part of that is communicating with all the people that love the same thing that we love is sports and entertainment and all of those things. And I missed all that interaction.
And, Brent, that trickles down to your teammates. Imagine the people that he has an opportunity to go play with, them listening to that, like, he's not the guy that really wants it. What do you mean? He's not signing up for a Super Bowl. Well, that's what we're here for. Outside of professional sports, high school, okay, I understand. College, I understand. Pros, once you start to get paid for it, it's different expectations.
It's a job,
buddy.
And your teammates are counting on you.
Exactly.
To
we need
want
you
to run through a brick wall to win a championship.
Right. If I can't close my eyes and point at one of my teammates, and whichever one I point to, he be the one to run through the brick wall, I don't need you on my team, man.
Am I wrong to not like Trevor Lawrence? And I'm not talking about personally. We're not talking about that. I don't know him. I'm not talking about that. Like, when I talked about my disdain for Timmy and that Kentucky team, it had nothing to do with who he is as a person because I don't know.
Yeah.
But his game.
Yeah.
So, like, Trevor Lawrence, to me, is going to be the most hated player for Titans fans. It's coming. Get ready.
Yep.
And I'm already on it.
Good.
I'm already on it.
Good.
And so the guy never loses. He's got great hair. He asked his girlfriend to marry him on the football field. Like, it's a storybook thing. It's a storybook thing for him. He's going number one in the draft. He's going to Jacksonville. He's going to – you want to talk about intense dudes?
Yeah.
This is where the rubber meets the road for me. Mm-hmm. Like, you got Trevor Lawrence making these comments, and Urban Meyer wants to win at all costs.
Everything.
So what does he really think about that comment? I'll bet there was a conversation after he read that.
I guarantee it. I guarantee it. This is a reach out. Hey, let me ask you something.
we ain't drafted you yet.
Yeah,
man.
Wait a minute now. Hold on, Dad. I don't know who's in charge of that, but that shouldn't have gotten out. And I think if it did, my thing is, like Lewis Riddick said, if this came out about Justin Fields, where would we be? He already slipped a fifth.
Yeah, and
he'd probably be a fourth rounder.
See, and you could go down the Justin Fields comparison. I think if any of the other quarterbacks would have said it, it would have been a story.
Right. But I don't think any of them would have said it. That's the problem.
Because he's so comfortable.
You're so comfortable. Exactly. Exactly. And that's the problem. Something needs to be shaken up. We'll talk about that. We was going to talk about that bus thing. Who's going to be the biggest bus?
There are five quarterbacks that are going to go pretty high.
Mindset is huge.
Yeah. I still think – I said it last week. I think Mac Jones will end up with the Patriots. I don't think he's going number three. And it's funny because now Justin Fields is the betting favorite to go to San Francisco at number three.
Right.
But you want to talk about competitiveness?
Yeah.
I know that, you know – so who was it that said it? I don't even remember. That he was the first one out, last one there kind of guy. All I know is I watched the college football playoff, and Justin Fields got rocked.
Come on.
And stayed in there and competed.
Come on. Now,
Trevor Lawrence wouldn't.
Right.
But.
We got a sample size of what it's like. We saw that hit that he took. And not only did he come back in and compete, he put them boys out of their misery. So, that was impressive. As much as his comments mean something from Trevor Lawrence, what we got to see from Justin Fields means just as much also. I don't know if you got shot up at halftime or what, but
Probably, but still.
Yeah, you went out there and fought.
Yeah.
You know, with one more game remaining. Hey, I take that all day. Give me Warriors all day. I'm like Mike Singletary.
I just pulled up.
Can't win with them. Can't win without them. Won't coach.
It's funny that you mentioned that. I watched the 30-for-30 85 Bears last night with my 14-year-old. I was like, this is the best football team that ever was created. I'm telling you. I know they went 15-1 and the 72 Dolphins went undefeated. I get that and all that stuff. This was the best team.
Look at that mentality on that team.
He watched that with me, man. It was so much fun. You want to talk about competitors. And all of them are dealing with aches and pains and some. Mm-hmm. And Jim McMahon's dealing with early onset dementia. Right. And every one of them was like, I'd do it again.
Yeah.
I would do it again.
That brotherhood, dude, they were living the time of their lives for that year. That was amazing. All the way, not only with the players, but the coaches, too. Man, Buddy Ryan and those guys, man, that, can you imagine what those practices were like? They had to call them. And then it wasn't no, we're not going to put pass on the hit.
Oh,
them
yeah.
Dudes get after it. You got Hall of Fame guys on each side of the ball.
You know, Blaine got drafted by the Oilers. Buddy Ryan was a defense coordinator. Mm. So they looked at Blaine as that 4-6 guy.
Yeah.
That come that down hybrid and knock your head safety, off. Linebacker, corner guy.
Mm-hmm.
And he fits so well into the 46. But he said that Buddy Ryan, man, he wasn't joking around.
Yeah.
Like, if the offense wasn't giving effort on the practice field, he would pull the defense off the field and say, go to the locker room.
That's beautiful.
There was always this rift between Kevin Gilbride was the offensive coordinator and Buddy Ryan, the defensive coordinator, and they actually got into it on the sideline. You can Google search
that.
You can also watch the show. If you missed yesterday, Will Bowling, the executive director of digital content management here at 104.5. We give him different titles every day, but at least I don't use curse words in it like some people around here.
Yeah.
Well, sometimes I do. But anyway, you can watch the show. So look at the Zone feed, the Zone Twitter feed, and the link is there. You can catch us on Periscope, Twitter Live, YouTube. What else, Will? Facebook. Yeah, the Zone Facebook page and Twitch. So get us on Twitch. You can see two beautiful men right here.
Look at these mugs.
Look at this. I'm wearing the three-hour lunch throwback shirt. You've got the Boom Boom Room shirt.
Man, we're out here.
We need a headband. Somebody needs to bring a headband to the radio station.
Next opportunity that I get, the headband will be on, people. And I told Brent, the more and more I come in here, I'm going to get a little portable hoop, and we're going to put it up. So y'all going to be able to see me and Brent play one-on-one during the breaks. How about that?
I love it. Orange and White on Twitter. Herb just started having heart problems after Trev's comment.
Oh, yeah.
I guarantee you there was a phone call.
Now, Herb, now listen, now we all know let something not be going right. Herb, look, stage left exit. He get on out of there with y'all too now. He ain't got no problem folding this tent up and going home.
And at 3HL 104.5 Sleigh Ride, let's go. At Ron Slay 35, at Brent Doherty.
Yeah.
And Mr. Caples, that was cousin Caden. Mr. Caples, the mayor, and hashtag Sleigh Ride on 3HL. With some applause. Yeah, we're going to have some fun today. I'll go ahead and tell you, Slay and I were talking about this before the show. We're going to bounce around on a lot of different things.
Oh, yeah.
We've also got Trash Talk Friday for you at 4:15. We've got Shoot Your Shot, which means you're locked for the weekend at 5:45. We've got Vanderbilt women's basketball coach Shea Ralph at 3:45, and we've got Jayson Swain, the CEO of the Swain event. He created it. It's his name. 4:45 coming up. So stay tuned. When we come back, John Fulkerson –
Wookie McFly.
He released his decision on the internet today. Not gonna lie, I got a little dusty when I took a listen and why. We'll play that for you when we come back. 3HL 104.5 The Zone.
We're more invested in this upcoming Titans season than Bitcoin.
Because, well, we really don't understand what Bitcoin even is.
From the draft to the first game, it's wall-to-wall Titans coverage on your smart speaker. Hey, Alexa, play 104.5 The Zone.
Hey, guys, you want some bonus points with your significant other? I got you covered, and it would be called a Moments Peace Salon and Day Spa. You know, there's a lot of couples nowadays. You want to do something, you want to bond, here you go, a Moments Peace Salon and Day Spa. You can do couples pedicures. You can do couples massages. You can just send your girl in for a massage or a manicure, pedicure, waxing, sunless tanning, skincare, facial. There's a hair salon there. They have makeup, you name it. All you have to do, 24/7 gift cards available online at their website at amomentspeace.com. You can also call them on the phone, 615-224-0770. If you have a question, maybe have a special request, you can always stop by. Personal service there in Cool Springs. It's across Interstate 65 from Galleria Mall at the intersection of Carruthers Parkway and Bakers Bridge Avenue. I'm telling you, everybody loves a unique and thoughtful gift. A Moments Peace Salon and Day Spa is where you can do it.
Some things are just true. Like Geico makes it easy to save on boat insurance. And also, a long boat ride is way better than a long car ride.
Are we there yet?
No, not yet.
Awesome! More boating! More boating!
Switch to Geico, and you could save hundreds on boat insurance. It's just true.
After 2 long years, Genesis Diamond Spectacular Spring Extravaganza is back. April 23rd through 25th. 3 incredible days. Store-wide savings. Up to 35% off Genesis already guaranteed best price on engagement rings, earrings, bracelets, wedding bands, plus special financing. This is the big one. The one where they break all the rules. Even Genesis GIA certified diamonds are marked down. Plus, top jewelry designers are flying in their entire collections. You've waited long enough. So don't miss this. April 23rd through 25th at Genesis Diamond. Green Hills and Cool Springs. Unapproved credit.
You've waited 2 years for it, but the wait is almost over. Genesis Diamond's store-wide spring extravaganza is next weekend. April 23rd through 25th. This is the big one. A store-wide sale unlike any other. Extra savings up to 35% off. They're already guaranteed best prices on virtually everything. Rings, earrings, bracelets, pendants, colored gemstones, even GIA certified diamonds are on sale. Don't miss it. Best prices and special financing too. 3 days only, April 23rd through 25th. Only at Genesis Diamonds, Green Hills and Cool Springs.
Dickens Turf and Landscape Supply. I want to talk with you about my friends there. Spring is here, and Dickens Turf and Landscape Supply is ready with all the fertilizer, seeds, pre-emergence, and herbicides needed to get your property ready for the year. Trey Hartsook is here with us to tell you more about what Dickens Supply has to offer. What's up, Trey?
Hey, bro. What's up, dude? Hey, man, I'm going to tell you what. Starting to warm up a little bit. Starting to feel more like spring. So, no, it's been cold the last couple of nights. I'm going to tell you what I'm seeing a lot of, Brent. Seeing a lot of weeds out there, a lot of clover patches, dandelion, chickweed. We don't like that at Dickens Turf and Landscape Supply. We know that that can take a great lawn and make it look not so great. So if you're having any of those issues at all, stop in at Dickens Turf and Landscape Supply. Let's ID those weeds, get them knocked out, get those things back to where, hey, we know we can have a great lawn going forward. Also, time of the year, spring. Want to make sure our equipment's running good. Make sure that weed eater's good, backpack blower's good, lawnmower's good, all those things. Make sure they're good. If yours ain't just running right, you can bring it in, Dickens Turf and Landscape Supply, service it, get it back going, bring it back from the dead. We can do that. Or if it's time, you just want to throw it in the trash, get you a new one. At Dickens Turf and Landscape Supply, we can do that for you. Stop in and see us. Configure located all over Middle Tennessee. Locations Nashville, Cool Springs, Hendersonville, Murfreesboro, Bellevue, Brewell Lawnmower, Mount Juliet, and Franklin. Open up at 7 a.m., closing at 4:30 Monday through Friday, 8 to 12 on Saturdays. If you can't get a hold of us, check us out online. DickensSupply.com.
The unexpected comes calling. From rent increases to increased orders to, I'm going to say it, unprecedented times. But don't bounce back. Bounce forward with Comcast Business. Bounce forward with fast, reliable internet on the network that can deliver gig speeds to the most businesses and gives you the flexibility to update your bandwidth in just a few clicks. Be fast. Be flexible. Be ready for what's next and bounce forward with Comcast Business. Help your business bounce forward with this amazing offer. Get started with a powerful and reliable internet and voice solution from Comcast Business. Starting at just $35 each a month for 24 months for 2 years when you buy both. Call 1-800-501-6000 or go to ComcastBusiness.com today to find out more. Restrictions apply. Limited to new Comcast Business 35 megabits per second internet and one voice mobility customers. Early termination fee applies. Enrollment in EcoBill and AutoPay required. Call for details.
We all know that Mr. Good Roof is your favorite roofing company. But did you know that Mr. Good Roof also does windows? Mr. Good Roof offers a variety of replacement windows to choose from that are guaranteed to satisfy your design taste or maybe your significant other's picky design taste. And they'll save you money on your heat and air bill, too. From roofs, windows, to gutters, even siding, Mr. Good Roof has you covered. Now, let's also talk about your roof. When was the last time you were up there? You know what kind of shape it's in, do you? What if you need a repair or even a replacement? What if you got storm damage? Don't trust one of the door knockers. Call Mr. Good Roof, a locally owned family business that Middle Tennesseans have trusted for years. Mr. Good Roof is licensed and insured, and they always have a supervisor on site in case you have questions. Visit Mr. Good Roof showroom in Hendersonville or call them at 615-824-8100.
Geico for your boat. See how much you could save at geico.com today.
Is your company hiring? We can help. Invest in your workforce at tnjobfair.com.
3HL1045 is on Trash Talk Friday coming up at 4:15. You got some trash talk to work out today? It'll make you feel better. You got some trash talk, Slay?
I got plenty of trash talk, all built up. And I got somebody I'm aiming it at. You let me know when to go. Let me know when to go, and I'm shooting.
4:15-ish. 5:45 as we get out of here on the live version of 3HL. Shoot your shot. You're locked for the weekend.
Got one of those, too.
Preds taking on the 10 last night against Carolina. Will Bowling sat in here and said, Preds are going to lose 5-0. And when it hit 3-0, I was like, wow. I almost texted Will and said, damn it, dude. You just spoke that into existence. And it was close.
Hey, man.
Executive Director of Digital Content, Will Bowling, in studio watching his Braves with a 4-2 lead now.
What's up? The
you
Preds
just felt
are,
that coming?
Preds are undefeated in shootouts, so they're being buoyed by a stat that is not going to help them in the postseason. No, it's not being negative. It's the truth. They're a good team. They deserve credit for coming back and becoming relevant again, but they went on a run in 2017 because they couldn't win shootouts.
How do you know, though, if those were playoff games and they didn't go to a shootout, uh-huh, that they wouldn't ultimately win in like two overtimes?
Okay, uh-huh. Well, you're not going to go 6-0-0, though.
Well, maybe you do.
Brent.
Stranger things have happened, Will.
They're not going to go undefeated in those games like they are in shootouts. They're a good shootout team. That's basically a skills competition. It's not actually the game. They're good at a skills competition.
It's fun, though.
It'd be like if at Tennessee, if game was tied at the end going into overtime, they have a three-point shooting contest. Tennessee goes undefeated in three-point shooting contest. Then you actually have overtime basketball in the NCAA tournament. Well, that doesn't help you. In 2017, they couldn't win a shootout. They get the 8 seed. They come and, we don't have to play shootouts anymore. We can win these games. Now it's the opposite.
You know what? I bit the low-hanging fruit, though, Will. You know, I went out and I bet on the game.
Oh, look at you, Slack.
I bet, the whole time without winning, I'm like, you know what? I ain't doing it. I ain't going to bite. And last night,
you bite. That's what
And that's when they got drugged. Yep. So what I want to do is go back and double up. But they're on the road.
Not against Carolina.
I know, and it scares
me. They can never beat Carolina.
They're beating them tomorrow. I'm going to go ahead and shoot my shot now.
There it is.
Yeah.
There we
go. While you give up another homer. What's going on here?
Oh, so did.
No, maybe that was a highlight.
That's a replay of the first one.
I'm going to go ahead and do it. I'm shooting my shot early. Hey,
I see.
They're 0-5 against the Hurricanes.
They're
this season.
Due.
Hey, they all do.
They're due.
So, Will, are you telling me I need to side with you or I need to go with Brent? Convince me.
They're winning.
Depends on who's in goal.
Okay.
They might go back to Peck Arena again. Then you really should bet Hurricanes.
Will, get emotional with this. Give an emotional pick here.
I'm right now leaning to Brent.
I don't
Brent
know if the people want me to
me.
Be emotional. Trying to tell the people how to make some money.
Here's why you're leaning toward me. I'm here a better salesperson than him.
Yes.
I don't know about that. And because your sales pitch was be emotional, and my sales pitch was they're 0-5 against Carolina.
They're due.
6-0 in shootouts, and that's about it.
Okay.
Who's in goal? I was giving you facts, and Brent's over here trying to win you with emotion. Emotion isn't selling you anything.
I don't need facts. I got it in here.
You got to go with the gut.
There's a gut pick, and I got a big gut. It's like,
guess what? During the break, I'm putting my money on the Preds. Now, if this goes left.
Hey, I'm going to Brent. You don't know where I live, do you?
Exactly. I'm going.
We're not Kelly? That close, are we?
Kelly! If you see the big black guy outside on the patio, it's me. Don't be alarmed. I'm looking for Brent. Just give him up and everybody else can relax.
I got a really nice grill out back, too. See? You want to work that while you're there?
I get to work
back
there.
I love your Instagram. I can smell your Instagram videos when you start
That's
cooking.
That's true.
Yeah. Yeah, it's serious. And I got another. I got a special sauce, too.
Special sauce.
I just came up with.
Oh, you like mix stuff together?
Yeah, but this is, man, this, I'm just let you taste it. I ain't even going to, boy, this is special.
Why are you keeping secrets over here?
Cause I got to, man. You can't give up everything when it comes to cooking, man. I hold this near and dear to my heart, man. Like, I just can't do it.
All right, we got a lot to get to. We were already talking about the 5 quarterbacks. By the way, Keyshawn Johnson has Justin Fields listed number one ahead of Trevor Lawrence. I love it. Trevor Lawrence not rated number one by one guy.
Get him, Keyshawn.
615-737-1045. Tennessee, Vandy baseball coming up this weekend.
I want some of that.
Will Bowling said students started camping out outside of Lindsey Nelson's stadium about 1 o'clock.
Let's go Rocket Top. We ain't here to play around.
Josh Heupel throwing out the first pitch tonight at 6.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, lefty.
Let's go to Frying Pan next up on 3HL. Hang on, Gator Mike. We'll get to you. Frying Pan, what's up?
Hey, guys. Love the show. Hey, I just wanted to kind of just chime in. You know, excited about Fulkerson coming back for a 6th year. You know, the recruiting class that Barnes has got coming in again. you know, with all these talented guys coming in, these expectation levels are high, man. They were high this past season, and we fizzled out the first round. I like Rick Barnes. It's time to win, man. It's time to win and get away from being regular season Rick. But we'll see how it shakes out, but that's my opinion. What's your thoughts, Ron? What do you think about that, buddy?
Ron, are you afraid of high expectations?
You know what? When we have a point guard like this, no. No. A lot of it hinges on that. I like that, man. That was good little tag, regular season Rick. You know what? That was pretty cool right there, man.
Was it regular season Ron too? Yeah,
I wish they would've. We had a guy try that, Brad Shepard, my guy who wrote for the Daily Beacon. He tried that and he sent me on a tear my sophomore year, ended up making 13 all SEC off the bench.
Oh, he criticized in the student newspaper?
Man, no, went at my neck, Brent.
Went at your neck?
Man, I'm talking about, I think I was, I don't even know if I was coming off an injury or what, but it was like two or three games to start the season, and I admit it wasn't the same punch that I was adding, but the energy and everything was there. The shots just wasn't falling. And he went in the paper and said, has Slay hit the sophomore slump or sophomore wall or something?
Oh, yeah. And I'm like, what? That goes back to Mark Macon at Temple. Look it up, kids.
Oh, man, I told Coach Green, hey, and Craig Pinkerton was the SID at the time. Okay. Craig, let me go in there and talk after I had a good game. I said, well, I appreciate Brad Shepard. Everybody in the nation can thank Brad Shepard for this. So you want to be known? I'm going to let you be known. And it was on. That's my man, though. I got to talk to him probably about 2 years ago. That was my first time talking to him.
I love that you still remember that guy's name.
Yeah, I couldn't forget it. I couldn't believe after everything I did, I was just sixth man of the year, man. Y'all going to – off of two or three games, that's what you're going to do?
Yeah.
But expectations, love where they are. You got a point guard. You got big men. You got shooters. You got athletic wings. Sweet 16, early prediction.
Scott on Twitter, we'll go through the people. For people that missed it, Tennessee's had a big couple of days in basketball. We'll go through that in just a second. Also, we're going to play the Fulkerson decision audio from the video, and you'll want to hear that. Scott on Twitter, I have to disagree about Trevor Lawrence's hair. It's stringy and thin. If you're going to have long hair, you need to have better hair than he has.
Yeah.
Wow. A blast at Trevor Lawrence's hair.
Yeah. What you know. It's nothing like Jeff Jarrett.
You know that? Yeah, that's right.
I'm Golden Locks.
615-737-1045. Gator Mike next up. Mike, what's up, man?
Hey, what's up, fellas? What's up, Slay?
What's up, Mike? How you doing, brother?
Hey, first off, Brent, I thought you or Will would have shot your shot with Tennessee baseball over Vandy. Anybody going to take that?
Yes. Yes.
Well, I mean, we might have left that one open.
Yeah, that's open for a reason.
It seems like that this thing is constantly out of control, but there is a rhyme to the reason.
Yeah, I got this. And then, Slay, you know, if you bring that hoop in the studio, you got to get that one like I sent you on Twitter the other night, the one you can hang on.
Dude,
you got to show Brent that video.
Hey, man,
Brent,
where
it's like
is
a
that?
A hoop that these kids can hang on in their house.
Like a real-life breakaway hoop, Brent. I mean, they going to bell, thunder dunking, boom, and hanging on the rim, and it don't break. Like, I've never seen, I don't know how they, don't worry, Gator Mike, I'm on it. Amazon.
Also, too, Brent, you know, we talk about great movies.
Yeah.
Brent, tell me you've seen The Town.
The Town?
Yeah.
Brent. I don't think so.
Slay.
Oh, we're, I got
him. Get him on The Town.
I got him. I'm on him, Gator Mike.
Listen, I go through phases where I think I'm out of everything. And I'm currently in one. So I need stuff to watch.
I got you. The Town, dude. Ben Town. Affleck directed.
But it's solid.
And starred
in. Finally, Slay, what I really called for, I just wanted to shoot the crap with y'all for a minute. But,
I love that.
Hey, talk about really the differences in the physicality of the game. I know a lot of it is rules related, but like from basically when you played college and pro versus to how it is now, you know, what you like, what you dislike about it. You know, I'm just really curious as a former player because, you know, my kids and I always get into arguments. I'm like, you know, LeBron would be messed up in the old NBA, I think, because of how physical it was and stuff. He'd have to adapt and quit being a crybaby.
Mm-hmm.
But I just wanted to get your take on it. I'll hang up and listen, but always great to talk to you, my friend.
Appreciate it, good, Mike.
Dude, if LeBron had to go against those Pistons teams back in the day, he'd be standing over in the corner.
Now, one thing I will say, it's so difficult for me to watch the NBA right now because there's so much whining every single play.
I hate it.
Like, it's – and I love the NBA. I love basketball.
I know.
Dude, I mean, it's – and I was listening to you and Babs yesterday, and you got – and she was talking about me. I watched 3 minutes of it, and I kind of understand why. Like, dude, I can't look at every single play that somebody's going to cry. The offensive guy and the defensive guy, then when they walk to the scores board to say – who the foul was on, then the coaches are whining. Like, it's too much every play, man. Like, save that at least for the playoffs. Let's beat each other up in the regular season or vice versa. Once we get to the playoffs, cut all that whining out, man, and let's play ball. But I think it's different generations, man. Once they took the hand-checking out of it,
yeah,
basketball got so soft, so soft. And then you put the replay in it, made it even softer. Like, it's ridiculous. In my day, oh, we were ready to bang, baby. We were ready to bang. That's why the Boom Boom Room. You see, we send people out of there. You see what Aaron Donald, you know what I mean? He's a lifetime membership guy now. You know what I mean? We send him out of there, eyes closed. And not because of the libations that's in there. You get knocked up in this Boom Boom Room, man. So,
wait, hey, what? Man.
Yeah, that was, yep. Didn't mean that one. You get knocked around in this boom boom. Don't get knocked up in there. Excuse me, people.
It's a different kind of boom boom.
That is definitely a different boom. Hey.
Speaking of, congrats to Jay Martin Abbey on the birth of their baby.
There you go. Good transition right there. Definitely salute.
They were in the boom boom room a little while ago. Scott. Abby's like, they're probably riding home. Right now from the hospital, listen, Abby's like, wait a minute, you work at that radio station? Good Lord, what is going
is
on?
Is that what the shirt means? No, people. No. No, this is not studio. What is it? Studio 50? What is it? Studio 52? 54, yeah. 52,
yeah. 54, whatever 50, it takes.
One of them. Yeah, 54.
Scott, yo, Ron Slay, you can't give up everything. You give them everything but the most important ingredients.
Yeah.
Hashtag cook your own stuff.
My man, there you go. And the sauce is important, man. And how you put the sauce on. Sometimes you pour the sauce. Sometimes you brush the sauce.
Is there some Louisiana hot sauce in there somewhere?
No, not in this one. I got one with, well, I stole it from Ramon. Ramon make a good little spicy sauce.
Okay, who's the better cook then while we're sitting here? Ramon Foster or Ron Slay?
In
on
what?
The grill. You grill whatever you want. He grills whatever he wants. Who's more satisfied?
I tell you this. He does a gas grill. I do a charcoal grill. So, to me, he cheats sometimes because he can get his done so quick. But my thing is, if you look at it,
are you playing video games? What is this?
It's throwing me off. I don't know what's going on. It's throwing me off. But this is the thing. If you look at it, he's good at steaks. Moan is really, really good at steaks and what's the shoulder. And oh, making the shoulder. Oh, yeah. My gosh. It's phenomenal. Now, me, I'm chicken. Ain't nobody going to mess with me in no chicken and burgers and ribs.
Chicken's hard to learn how to cook.
Hey, man, you got to know what you're doing.
There's a razor-thin window.
Yes, it is. You can burn it. It can be not good enough.
Or you can make people sick.
Which one you want to do? Make people happy, make people sick. I'm on the happy end of this.
Orange and White says, apparently Ron's talking about the VIP boom boom room.
Yeah, that was, you know, hey, man, hey, guess what? That's a different membership.
The champagne boom boom room.
Yeah. Hey.
All right, we got to get Folky in here. I'm telling you, man, a buddy of mine, Chris, sent me this. I hadn't seen it yet.
Yeah.
So this is a video. We'll tweet it out after we play this, but the audio works because it's Folky telling a story leading you up to his decision of whether or not to come back. Check this out, Kevin.
It seems like just yesterday that I was a little kid in Kingsport, Tennessee, developing a love for the game of basketball by watching UT teams led by guys like Wayne Chisholm, Skylar McBee, and Tyler Smith. Those guys grew up in Tennessee and worked hard enough to earn the opportunity to be a Vol. They were like heroes to me. They helped me to believe that maybe one day I could follow in their footsteps. Fast forward to today, and that kid in Kingsport is now a man who looks back on the 5 incredible years that I was blessed to try to be a role model for the next generation of dreamers. I still sometimes ask myself if this has all been real. Am I really a Tennessee volunteer? God is great. He blessed me with the opportunity to play for a legendary coach alongside some legendary players and contribute to some unforgettable wins. I've gained a couple dozen lifelong brothers. I've developed a network of friends and mentors that I cherish, and I've learned lessons that I'll apply to the rest of my life. I've tried my hardest to do it all the right way, day in and day out. I understand who and what I represent, and I've never taken that lightly. Playing big-time college basketball comes with a pressure that's hard to describe. I know I haven't been perfect. I hope I've made people proud and haven't let anyone down. Imagine if I could go back in time and talk with that young version of myself back in Kingsport. Would he believe the things he grew up to experience? What would he think of these last few years? What would he think about the last time I walked off the court in Nashville?
The big concern for Fulkerson down the road, the impact this has on his ability to return.
What would he think if I told him I had the chance to do it all one more time, to walk off the court on my terms? I think I know what he'd want me to do, and I'm not about to let him down. Trust in the Lord with all your heart, and do not lean on your own understanding. In all your ways, acknowledge him, and he will make straight your paths. My path still points to Rocky Top. This opportunity is too special to walk away from. Vol Nation, I'm back. Beautiful
morning. Chills, man. Chills, man. That is a great way to make
what
an announcement.
What I'm talking about, man.
We'll put the video out there. Y'all need to see it. Zach weighing in. I'm holding back tears.
Hey, man.
Hashtag Folky forever.
Dude, I'm trying to figure out how did I just get emotional like that, man?
And you've seen it already.
And I've already seen it, dude. Yeah. Golly.
That's number 3 for me.
That's what I'm talking about. But guess what, though, Brent? We were talking, and that was one of the things, man, when we were talking, why would Folky come back? Everything that you've given to this university and this team and this program, you don't want to leave it like that. Because the way you came in and set the standard and set the foundation, that's not the way you want to lead a program. That's not it. And you didn't even have an opportunity to put your imprint on it. Nah. He answered that perfectly, man.
Beautifully, man.
Oh, that was big time.
Yeah, man. We'll talk more about that as the show goes on. I'll ask you the question. If you were him, what would you have done? That's coming up. When we come back, Vanderbilt women's basketball coach Shea Ralph. She just spent a bunch of time on the bench next to Gino Auriemma winning mm-hmm. championships. She was a hell of a player
mm-hmm.
back in the day. And I would argue that the combo of Jerry Stackhouse and Shea Ralph is winning any two-on-two matchup with any other coaching combination in the SEC.
Yes,
that's happening. Shea Ralph next on 104.5 The Zone.
Real life awaits Blaine and Mickey.
Real life awaits. Like you push that door open and you peek out of it.
Blaine and Mickey, Monday from 1 to 3 p.m.
104.5 The Zone.
Buddy Allen Carpet One has the Closet Pause flooring sale going on. Pets bring so much joy to your home. They also bring lots of wear and tear, specifically to your floors. We're talking about scratches, spills, accidents, and more. That's why at Buddy Allen Carpet One, they carry a wide range of pet-friendly floors, including carpet, hardwood, tile, and luxury vinyl. Flooring that is designed to withstand what your furry friends dish out and stay looking beautiful, allowing you to enjoy your pets and keep loving your home. Now through May 17th, during the Closet Pause flooring sale at Buddy Allen Carpet One, you will save up to $1,000 on new floors of your dreams. You'll get special financing with approved credit. Enjoy zero interest if paid in full within 12 months on purchases made with your Carpet One Synchrony Home credit card. Go check these guys out. The showrooms in Donaldson, 2405 at Lebanon Pike. Give them a call, 615-883-3289. Check them out online, buddyallencarpet1.com.
These are uncertain times, to say the least, but one thing that is certain is the level of service you can expect to receive from Aaron's Garage Doors. Hi, I'm Aaron Moore, owner of Aaron's Garage Doors. I started my business over 20 years ago in Wilson County, so I can safely say we are truly a local company you can feel good using. You've been putting off having your garage door serviced or repaired, even replaced. We offer great finance options. Call me at 615-456-6654 for a free, no-obligation quote. That's 615-456-6654 or visit aaronsdoorservice.com today.
Switching your car insurance to GEICO is both easy and could save you hundreds. It's the best of both worlds. Like a butcher with a sense of humor. A co-meat Ian.
Well, I'd tell you a joke, but I'd probably butcher it. The stakes are too high.
GEICO. Easy and savings. The best of both worlds.
BetMGM welcomes you to Showtime with a risk-free first bet up to $600. Simply sign up and use bonus code MGM600 and you're on your way to betting with the king of sportsbooks. Plus, with BetMGM's new one-game parlay feature, you can choose from hundreds of bet types and combinations within a single game to build the perfect parlay. All the action on all your favorite sports will be at your fingertips when you download the app or go to BetMGM.com and use bonus code MGM600 to make your first bet risk-free up to $600. Bet with confidence and turn game day into payday at BetMGM. New customer offer, paid in free bets. Must be 21 years or older. Must be in Tennessee. Visit BetMGM.com for full list of terms and conditions. For problem gambling support, call the Tennessee Red Line at 800-889-9789.
Fleet Cards USA.
Fleet Cards USA, Barb here.
Hey, Barb, I've got a lawn care company.
Ooh, we work with home services all the time. Experts in that area.
Well, I need more credit for my business.
Look no further. Fuel cards are a great way to manage expenses and cash flow. Plus, your guys have a convenient way to fuel up.
Wow, that sounds easy.
Easy's my middle name. Not really. It's Hildegard.
Oh, sorry about that.
Go to FleetCardsUSA.com, answer a few questions, and woo, you're good to go.
Fleet Cards USA.
Summer is almost here, and that means backyard grill outs. And no backyard grill out is complete without Omaha Steaks. Order the mouth-watering Let's Go Grill package today. Visit OmahaSteaks.com and enter keyword zone in the search bar to save over 45%. Plus, you'll get the tasty bonus of 12 ultra-juicy Omaha Steaks burgers free. That's almost 4 pounds of free burgers. To top it off, you'll also get $20 off your first order. The Let's Go Grill package includes 4 butcher-cut filet mignons, 4 boneless pork chops, 1 pound of chicken breasts, 4 kielbasa sausages, and so much more. Here's to warmer days filled with fun family memories and epic backyard grill outs featuring the best steak of your life, guaranteed. Go to OmahaSteaks.com, use the code ZONE in the search bar, and for a limited time, you'll get 12 free Omaha Steaks burgers, and on your first order, get $20 off at checkout. That's OmahaSteaks.com, keyword ZONE.
I want to tell you about my friends at Smoky Mountain Tops. They've done multiple projects for us in multiple houses along the way as we buy and sell over time. And product's always amazing. The time with which it takes, always on time, on point, all of those things. Beautiful countertops. And that's what you're going to find with Smoky Mountain Tops. They are the absolute best. New countertop, centerpiece of any kitchen or bath. Whether you're remodeling or doing new construction, that countertop selection is going to go a long way in determining the overall look of your dream kitchen or bath. It makes a huge difference. Just go in and see my guys at Smoky Mountain Tops. Give them a call. 615-331-8786 is the number. You can check them out online, smtops.com. Smoky Mountain Tops, one of the few who are fully accredited with the Marble Institute of America. They offer the widest range of quartz, granite, and marble available. Smoky Mountain Tops, give them a call today. Again, 615-331-8786. Check them out online, smtops.com. Smoky Mountain Tops, quality, service, and dedication.
GEICO. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
From the 104.5 The Zone Traffic Center.
Dealing with an injury crash now at M Hill Pike at Spence Lane and have a stalled vehicle blocking the right shoulder southeast of town at I-24 westbound after Bell Road. East of town, we have a crash at I-40 eastbound right before we get to Briley Parkway, and near the airport, the left shoulder's blocked from a stalled vehicle at I-40 eastbound just west of Donaldson Pike. Also, we have an injury crash at I-40 eastbound near the exit ramp to Charlotte Avenue and another crash in East Nashville at Ellington Parkway and heading northbound near Douglas Avenue. I'm Joshua Clay with traffic on your home for Titans football, 104.5 The Zone.
Tell 104.5 The Zone. Check out the video feed. I don't know what Slay's doing over there. You dancing during breaks?
Yeah.
People can't see that, though.
Doggone it. You missed it.
Yeah, you missed it.
I just moonwalked all the way from Coach Mack back over here to my seat, which is Babs' seat. Salute to Babs.
We're trying to get with Shea Ralph, the new Vanderbilt basketball coach. Looking forward to that. We picked now to change our phone system over, so we're going to try to – move her to another segment. But I want to check in with her because, Slay, you're over there winning national titles as an assistant coach at UConn. You know your phone's ringing.
Yeah.
What is it about Vanderbilt?
That's the question.
That's the question, right?
That is the question.
And she was a stone cold player, too.
Yes, she was.
Player of the year back in the day. Won a national title in 2000.
Very competitive.
And when you were at Tennessee, that Lady Vol UConn thing was something.
Yeah. I loved when they were going to play – was it La Tech when they played UConn? Those games, man, were those were different, you know. And then you get to see a different type of atmosphere. The ladies get up for it differently, you know, than the regular season game versus a team like Kentucky or something. When UConn comes to town, it's different, man. I used to love seeing them lock in, especially Tamika Catchings, and when Coach Summit used to put that 12 in the air. Or was it a 12 or diamond? I think the 12 was for the diamond press, if I'm not mistaken. Y'all call in and let me know. But that used to mean it's time to turn up, and I'm not taking my foot off their throat. I used to love it. I used to love that killer mentality, man. That was it. That was it. I love that. I love watching the women play because of that.
Well, I mean, back then, you want to talk about athletes?
Yeah. Yeah.
Samika Randall and Tamika Catchings and all the Meeks.
Yep.
They were inheriting the basketball floor and the earth and everything that went with it. Yeah, national titles, rings, everything.
Yep. Now, you talking about a special program? That was it. And the funny thing is, we knew what they were going to do because they got the opportunity to play with us in summer league every now and then. Like, when we played summer pickup. So, we would let Tamika Catchings, play. You know, Samika Randall play. Nicky McCray, when they came back, we let them play. You know, one or two, you know, sub in every now and then if we short.
Well, I mean, Jerry Green's just rolling the ball out. I mean,
we're going to go shirts and skins. Why was his fingers? Why does his fingers always curl up like this when he says shirts?
Is that what he did?
We're going to go shirts. I guess he didn't want to point at nobody. We're going to shirts and skins. That's my man. I love you. I love Coach Green, man. He just let us be us, man.
There's all kinds of food trash talk going on now. Ron, I think you tried to give an accurate.
I did.
I asked you an unfair question because Ramon Foster's not here.
Yep.
To defend himself or to brag on himself, whatever he wants to do. Who's the better grill guy?
And you said
Ramon with the steaks and the shoulder.
Without question.
And you with the chicken.
Chicken all day. If it's a party, he telling me to bring chicken. I'm telling him do them steaks with the blue cheese crumbles. I don't even eat blue cheese.
I'm not a blue cheese guy at all.
Dude, this is different.
It is?
I promise you. I can't stand blue cheese. Don't like the look of it or anything.
Ramon, y'all some fools, man. LOL, Studio 54. Give me my damn credit.
There's LeBron. He had his LeBron moment in our text chat. Hey, but guess what? I will give him this. That man put it together, man. He put it together, and it's quick. Like, big fella can cook. Big fella can cook. I'm gonna give him that. So, but Ramon's a behind the scenes type of cook. I'm gonna show you what I can do. I want the bells and whistles and everything.
You want to be on the stage?
There you go.
Yeah.
There you go. See, I might take some of his.
Yeah. While everybody's in the pool.
There you go. Yeah. And when everybody comes in, like, who cooked? I'm the first one to jump up. Hey, man, this is mine. You know, and then he lets me take the credit. So that's my guy.
So Ramon's the best, man. Ramon said, how dare y'all at Brent Doherty, at Ron Slade 35, LOL. Ron knows I'm cold on the grill, but yes, my steaks and shoulder fire. So I said, we need a cook-off. A few members of the Zone listening crew selected as judges.
Oh.
How about that?
Hey, he know I'm with it. But that I'm telling you the difference. Man, see, this is how you know he's a guy that gets after it. He got four different grills. Got a charcoal grill, a gas grill, an egg. They got all kind of stuff going on over there, man. You got a fire pit. Like, He got a lot going on. I'm just too grill shouty. That's what you call me. Too grill shouty. I'm gonna work the two grills and I'm gonna make them do with it. My salmon though, Brent. If you're a salmon guy, I'm pretty cold with the salmon too. I'm gonna be honest.
I'm trying, man. I'm trying to eat more fish, Ron.
Man.
I'm trying to eat more fish.
It gotta be cooked right for me.
It's good for you.
It gotta be cooked right for me. Red snapper.
Okay.
Ooh, Brent, it'll change your life.
For me on the grill, almost. I'm almost there. I've almost got the timing down on the jigging, but not quite. Could go one way or the other. Hey, I'm almost there with the burgers.
Everything almost. You're almost getting there.
I think my grill's too good for me is what it is.
You got gas?
Yeah. But it's my wife bought some super grill, and it's like super hot.
Yeah.
So everything takes like 3 seconds and it's done.
And it's over, yeah. Yeah. See, mine is more about.
Like the boom boom room.
Yeah, see, the boom boom room, man, it's a whole show. You know what I mean? It's about getting the charcoal ready. It's about the song you're going to play. It's about everything. You got to have the proper attire. You got to make sure you got the necktie on with the wife beater, with the little fan joint going, pointing at you, shorts, sandals, water, another cup with something else in it. It's a whole production when I get
so
on.
So do you have an apron with something ridiculous written on it?
Nah, I like to be in the wife beater. That's my apron.
I think
a very long wife beater.
2021, we'll probably have to come up with a different term for that. Yeah. Everybody knows what that is.
It's an undershirt. I told Lil Ron that yesterday, too.
You did?
I did. I told Lil Ron that. Yep. Yep. I've been good at that. It's your fault, Brent. You took me like we were out back at the patio just having a conversation. I forgot we were on air.
That's what I do to people.
Yeah, that's your fault.
Completely disarmed.
Any problems anybody got? Y'all aim
aiming at me?
Yeah. Kelly, it's not me.
I want your take on these quarterbacks, man.
Yeah.
Because there are five of them that are going to go high.
Mm-hmm.
And the J. Martin Ramon were running through like seven out of the last eight, taken in the first three, or never even made it out of their rookie contract with the same team.
Right. Right.
So what's going to happen with these guys? Who is the best shot to make it? I'm talking 5 years from now. Who is the best shot to be the bust? We'll talk about it next. 615-737-1045. You want in? We'll take a quick break.
We collect and analyze all the NFL draft data so you don't have to. Not because you're lazy, but because you're brilliant. Be brilliant. Just ask Alexa to play 104.5 The Zone.
This is Jim Rome with the CBS Sports Minute. We're now less than 2 weeks away from the NFL Draft, which is probably just enough time for the draft stock of Justin Fields to take about 50 more turns. Remember when Fields was regarded as the number two quarterback in the draft class going into last year? And then all of a sudden the narrative changes. Zach Wilson blows right by him. Mac Jones may have moved by him and might be the guy the Niners are looking for with that third pick. And then the whispers. You know, the stuff from unnamed sources questioning Fields' work ethic, and then speculation that he's not good at advancing beyond his first read. Folks suddenly questioning his desire to be great. I'm no draft expert, but I know garbage when I hear it. If you want to draft somebody else instead of Fields, great. But don't spew junk just to make somebody else look better, because you're just making yourself look worse. I'm Jim Rome.
Hi, this is Joe Cordell with the law firm Cordell & Cordell. When the prospect of divorce becomes a reality, you need a partner that you can count on. If you're a man in this situation, consider contacting Cordell & Cordell. We've helped men navigate complex legal matters for 30 years.
Contact Cordell & Cordell to schedule an appointment with one of our firm's Nashville area attorneys, a partner men can count on. Online at CordellCordell.com. 810 Crescent Center Drive, Suite 160, Franklin, Tennessee, 37067.
Why would I sell the car of my dreams for a food truck that wasn't?
Or rattle off condiment combinations in my sleep?
Extra mayo, all the mustard, ketchup on the side.
I mean, when did an app become my favorite tool? Nothing personal, Spatula. It's because I wanted to make the best burger ever. And QuickBooks' suite of tools helped me get there.
Intuit QuickBooks helps small businesses be more successful. Learn more at QuickBooks.com.
Sports betting, legal in Tennessee. Love that. Love local companies. Action247.com. That is the website for the legal local sports book. The only one. In Tennessee, action247.com. Slay was telling you, he threw down on some hockey yesterday.
Didn't work out for him, but he's got tomorrow to make it back, and he can do it. Action247.com. I use them. Slay uses them. For Tennesseans, by Tennesseans, local company. Again, the website, get signed up, action247.com. When you get signed up, use the promo code ACTION100. They'll match 100% of your deposit up to $100, so get that done. The apps are up and running as well, so download the apps, and you'll be off and running. Baseball, basketball, golf's fun, NASCAR's fun. Get involved. Go to the website and see all of the different promotions that they have going on. These guys are awesome. Again, the only local legal sports book. Action247.com. Download the apps. Must be 21 years or older and present in Tennessee to bet. For gambling problems, support, call the Tennessee Red Line at 1-800-889-9789.
Reading from the Golden Oak Lending Book of Mortgage Lingo.
What is a cash out refi? It's using the equity in your home to pay off high interest credit cards.
Paid it off! Yes!
I'm James Hawkins, president of Golden Oak Lending. With mortgage rates at a record low 1.875%, you can save hundreds each month and skip your next two payments. You'll pay nothing out of pocket, and we never charge for a home appraisal if we can't close your loan. And remember, our local lending experts speak mortgage and love translating for our customers. Eliminating debt means putting your dreams back on the table today.
Updated bathroom?
Updated bathroom and a pool table?
Don't push it, Rick.
Get started with our fast and easy zipline tool at goldenoaklending.com.
NMLS 114937. 1.875% fixed. 2.913% APR. FHA 15-year mortgage with 20% equity and approved credit.
Bad phone systems are bad for business. Poor clarity, lack of features.
We'll come back to that tomorrow.
Absolutely no support. Well, good news. Reliable VoIP does exist. VoIP from CSpire Business is a game-changing, stress-free communication system with crystal-clear audio and premium features, all backed by our team of experts, available 24/7. Now that's VoIP. CSpire Business. Stay connected with powerful communication tools at cspire.com/business.
Waiting for spring is one thing. Waiting for spring savings is another. At the Home Depot, you don't have to wait for either one. Our best prices of the season are here now, in-store, online, store-wide. Get a 40-volt battery-powered Ryobi string trimmer for just $159. And more savings on everything, from fresh paint to power blowers. You've waited long enough. Bring on spring. The Spring Savings Event, now at the Home Depot. How doers get more done. Valid through April 18th while supplies last.
Finding great candidates to hire can be like, well, trying to find a needle in a haystack, but not with ZipRecruiter. Its powerful technology actively finds and invites qualified candidates to apply to your job. So while other companies might deliver a lot of hay, ZipRecruiter finds you the needle in the haystack.
See why 4 out of 5 employers who post a job on ZipRecruiter get a quality candidate within the first day. Try ZipRecruiter for free at ziprecruiter.com/free. That's ziprecruiter.com/free.
Racing fans, 104.5 The Zone has been given a family four-pack of tickets to the General Tire 200 on Saturday, April 24th, and to the Geico 500 on Sunday, April 25th at Talladega Super Speedway, and we want to give them to you. NASCAR is excited to welcome fans back to Dega while operating in accordance with the state of Alabama's health and safety requirements. So sign up for your chance to win a family four-pack of tickets to race weekend at Talladega today by going to 104.5 TheZone.com/contest.
From the 104.5 The Zone Traffic Center.
Dealing with an injury crash now at Elm Hill Pike at Spence Lane and have a stalled vehicle blocking the right shoulder southeast of town at I-24 westbound after Bell Road. East of town, we have a crash at I-40 eastbound right before you get to Briley Parkway, and near the airport, the left shoulder's blocked from a stalled vehicle at I-40 eastbound just west of Donaldson Pike. Also, we have an injury crash at I-40 eastbound near the exit ramp to Charlotte Avenue and another crash in East Nashville at Ellington Parkway and heading northbound near Douglas Avenue. I'm Joshua Clay with traffic on your home for Titans football. 104.5 The Zone.
From the Mark Spain Real Estate Studios, this is your Titans NFL Draft Station. WGFX Gallatin Nashville. Trending now at 104.5 The Zone.
Good afternoon, I'm Will Bowling. John Fulkerson is coming back to Tennessee. He announced on his Twitter account today, the forward will return for his 6th season of eligibility under head coach Rick Barnes. Second-ranked Vanderbilt and third-ranked Tennessee this weekend in Lindsey Nelson Stadium in Knoxville. It's the first time ever that the Doors and the Vols will face off as top 5 opponents.
Nashville Soccer Club kicks off its second MLS campaign tomorrow night in Nissan Stadium. Kickoff is at 7:30 against FC Cincinnati. And the Predators will look to bounce back from a 4-1 loss last night against the Hurricanes again tomorrow. Puck drops at 7 against Carolina. Breaking news at once on your home for the Titans and Vols. This is 104.5 The Zone.
Driving you home every afternoon. This is the 3HL with Brent Doherty and Don Davenport.
HL 104.5 The Zone, hour number two. Brent Doherty, Ron Slay in for Don Davenport. She is covering the Auburn spring game. There are a bunch of them this weekend. And we've got a lot to get into. Already are. Kind of all over the board today. That's kind of what we do.
You think Don has fun when she goes back to Auburn? Like, if we were to go back to Rocky Top, you think she has more fun than we do?
I think Knoxville's more fun than Auburn.
I do too.
I've never been to Auburn, so maybe I shouldn't say that. But she said herself that you know, it's kind of in a remote area.
Yeah.
Kind of hard to get to. She loves it, obviously, but.
Nothing like Rocky Top.
Great. I mean, we're talking about spring games. You're talking about Rocky Top. You're making me want a tailgate, man.
Yeah. Hey, we're right there.
I think J. Martin Ramon and the crew, you may be involved in that.
Yeah, I'm sneaking up there. I'm getting
going up next weekend.
Yeah, I'm getting in the back in the trunk or something.
What do you think about Josh Heupel, man? Everything we hear out of there is struggle on D.
Yep.
They're getting it together a little bit on offense.
Right.
They do have some playmakers
yep.
on offense. Bayless Jones coming back was huge. Jalen Hyatt outside. A lot of guys that you thought you might see last year in terms of young guys that maybe you didn't,
mm-hmm.
that could get some run this year. Where are you with that football team?
You know what, man? I'm wide open and optimistic about what can go on, and I'm trying to be patient. Now, that is very difficult as a Vol fan, but – I think the key to being objective and optimistic about the season is staying off of social media. How you? I don't know it can't happen. I know Vol Nation will be on there heavy, and I'll be on there heavy too. But if we can just keep positive energy for 2 years, I think everything comes full circle, and we start to get things back in our favor. Like. Everything's thriving.
Hey, we've been patient for like 15 years.
So yes,
what's
we have.
Another 2 years?
That's all I'm saying, Brent. I mean, hey, man, we've been here this long. But I will say, being able to know some of the ins and outs and being able to talk to some of the people in the know up there, it's a different energy up there. It's a different energy. And I can't wait to get up there. And
I've heard that.
Yeah, and sneak up there with J. Martin Ramon and those guys. And I'm going to jump in the trunk and I'm going to just pop out and take off running.
Maybe.
Like.
Maybe you can get in a dodgeball game or something up there.
Ooh. They let me in that. Now, there's going to be some people out on IR after that because I got a missile. I'm slanging a
hey,
missile.
You throwing left and right-handed? That's my
oh,
secret.
Oh, yeah.
That's my secret deal.
And my thing is always block with the left, throw with the right, then come back, jump. Got a nice little jump matrix thing going on. Boom, popping with the left. Cold with the left, too, man.
I love it, man. That's what I hear, too, from parents
yeah.
that have kids on the team that the players love.
The energy, man.
This energy and attitude and all those things.
Like, it was some energy sucked out of there by Coach Pruitt, man, and what he had going on. And
not that he's a bad coach or anything like that, but he's a different kind of guy.
Exactly.
Like, he's just kind of low-key.
Yep.
And now he can get fired up and all those things. But there's just – I don't want to say there's, like, a negative air around him because that's taking it too far, but – It's definitely not – like, you're not around Pruitt, and you're like, you feel all this positive energy.
Right. This is what
is
I'm going to tell
fair?
You, Brent. Now, yeah, that's definitely fair. I'm going to tell you this, and you know this. You've been – your kids play sports, and you've been around sports long enough. Relationships are everything in sports.
In life.
In life, exactly.
I tell my kids that all the time. Look, you need the grades to get where you need to get.
Right.
But once you get that, once you get your degree, that gets you your first job. It's all about relationships.
Yeah.
Everything.
Yeah. So, and you're I think these kids, they have a good relationship and a good rapport so far with Heupel. I think he's not the stepfather that's come in to try to get things, clean up everything and be a disciplinarian and all of that. He's a guy to come in and refresh guys and revitalize the old Tennessee traditions and. Get everybody to buy in, and it's you can't say enough, man, when you brought in and you don't have to clean up a program. In this situation, it's already rubbish on the ground. He's forming his own. He's taking the clay and forming his own, whatever he wants. He doesn't have to clean up. He's not putting people off the team. Like, he is standing for something, but I like it, man. I like what I'm
doing. Rubbish on the ground.
We are. It's rubbish.
I like it.
Now, we're rubbish.
So,
we ain't dumpster juice, but well, we're rubbish.
Dumpster juice. So, yeah, develop quarterback. That's certainly going to be a thing that hasn't gone on there in a while.
Right.
Basically since Kiffin.
Yeah.
With Jonathan Crompton, turned him into a draft pick.
Yes, he did.
And then you had the Tyler Bray year where he almost threw for 4,000 yards, but I think that was more him doing it with the weapons he had. But, yeah, I mean, develop quarterback, and then maybe you got a guy that's in the conversation like we're having with these five quarterbacks that are going to go high in the draft. I saw Keyshawn Johnson put out a list before we started the show, and I thought it was interesting because he didn't go Trevor Lawrence number one.
Right.
Keyshawn went with Justin Fields. He said, I'm taking Justin Fields as my top quarterback over Trevor Lawrence, and I know a lot of people are saying, well, the Jags aren't going to do that. Whatever. These are my rankings. This is how I feel. I feel like when you look at a guy like Justin Fields who's gone through some adversity, as I mentioned, coming from the University of Georgia to a new offense, and Ryan Day lit it on fire in 2019, came into the situation, didn't know his teammates, didn't know anything, walked into the building, took the starting job, made players transfer from Ohio State at that position, and the rest has been history. One of those players that transferred is now the quarterback of the Cincinnati Bengals, Joe Burrow.
Right.
So he's got Justin Fields number one. So I'm not the only Trevor Lawrence hater out there.
No. You're not.
He does have Lawrence number two.
I think, man, that's the comfortable pick with Trevor Lawrence. Like,
I would take him number one, yeah, even though I'm saying all these negative things.
Yeah, you would
him.
Have to. But I do think Justin Fields jumps up to third. I think Zach Wilson is kind of locked in. I think it's enough out there. But I think Fields jumps up to three. Trey Lance is a guy that just jumped on the scene to me. I didn't get to watch a lot of Trey Lance.
Nobody did, because exactly. He only played one game last year.
See what
year.
I'm saying? Yeah. So, I mean, like, what are they seeing that we're not seeing? I mean, I like guys that are proven. Justin Fields is a guy that's proven. Zach Wilson, in a sense, is proven. Trevor Lawrence, we see what he can do, 36-2. I mean, you can't go against that, you know. But
Trey Lance with the high ceiling, low ground, mm-hmm. high risk reward guy.
Mm-hmm.
So you got to rely mm-hmm. on your scout there. He played 17 games at North Dakota State.
Right, right. So,
I don't know what to think about him.
What you think about Mac Jones?
I don't like Mac Jones.
You don't think he's?
I told you. Look, he was great at Alabama. He right, was. And he may turn out to be a great NFL quarterback.
Mm-hmm.
My thing is. Receivers were Alabama open, not NFL open,
mm-hmm.
right? And you had Alabama time to make a throw,
right?
Not NFL time to make a throw,
right?
So those are my questions with him,
right?
Now, you know, I'm no NFL scout, clearly, but I don't get all this Mac Jones number three to San Francisco thing,
right? I don't believe that. I'm gonna take a page out of Coach Mac's book. He said, "Don't believe any of this. It's all smokescreen." So.
Jayson Martin says, a season of lies.
There we go. So I think it falls 1, 2, 3, Lawrence, Wilson, Fields.
Well, and so the thought there is, there you go, Will Bowling. Something just happened for you. He's watching the Braves game.
Pump it up, Will.
Braves-Cubs game for Cubs fans out there. Let me include them. I don't have a dog in this hunt, although I do like the Cubs.
None of us do.
I like to watch the Braves play. I like this group of Braves.
I like it. It's exciting.
Yeah.
I mean, I love them in the playoffs.
Ronnie Acuna Jr., I just saw before the show, he's on pace for 87 homers, 212 runs, 175 RBI.
How many chains is he on pace to wear? That's the next question. Because that man is iced out during the game.
Did you wear chains when you played?
Man, no. I went out my Daryl Dawkins, Moses Malone. Like, I don't understand when people work out with it now. Like, they work out with the little choker necklaces on. I'm this guy. You come out there with it on, it's fair game. So when it gets snatched off, you can't get mad at me. I'm reaching for it. You know what I mean? I shouldn't know what I did. Take your jewelry off.
Part of it. We're coming to play.
Yeah, we you feel that comfortable that you can come out here in a necklace? Come on, man. Who you think you – that's disrespectful to me, man. Who you think you playing against, man? You going to wear a chain out here to play? No, dog, this ain't no fashion show.
One of my buddies texted me the other day and said that when Acuna beat out that grounder
on the first pitch of the game Sunday night against the Phillies. He said, well, he would have gotten there quicker if he didn't have these stupid chains around his
head. Yeah, exactly.
he wouldn't just be the 40-40 club. He'd be the 50-50 club if he didn't have a chain around his
head. It does cut off the wind flow as he runs.
What do you do if somebody grabs and then takes it off? What do you do?
Probably fighting somebody.
It's like the old conversation with Troy Polamalu's hair. What happens if somebody just...
Hair's part of it. You pull the hair.
I'm looking for any advantage. Like, I had somebody, when we played Kentucky, Keith Bogans, we was on the free throw line, pulled my headband down over my ass.
I remember that. I remember that now that you say that.
Yep. I was like, dude, what are you doing, dude? He's like, why would you have it on? Because this is what I do. What do you mean? And so the next, when we had a jump ball, we was on the bottom of the pile. He has a big scar on his arm because I took
like
my
a
nails.
Dog scar?
I took
oh,
my,
no, your scar.
Yeah, I took my nails and drug them. He got a big scar to this day. We're going to get him on the show too, Brent. I'm going to let him tell his story. Watch.
A couple times a game, Wayne Chisholm wore his headband so high on his head it'd fall off.
I couldn't stand that. I used to call Wayne and tell him. And when I
Old Weezy.
Call him when I was overseas. Yeah. And when I got back in the summer, I used to tell Wayne, why do you keep wearing that halo like that?
It kept being like a receding hairline. Yeah,
like,
what, you
got, a yarmulke without the middle part. Like, what are you doing?
There was one game, I think in the NCAA tournament, that he had four fouls and took the headband off and started hitting shots and took over
the
game.
Too.
I remember that, too.
Right.
I do, too.
That was what game was that? Was that that Butler game they went to overtime in Birmingham?
It may have been.
They beat American as the two seed. This was 2007 or 2008.
Yeah.
They beat American as the two seed. They went to overtime with Butler before they lost to Louisville in the Sweet 16. I'm pretty sure it's that Butler game in overtime.
See,
he took his headband off in overtime.
All right, real quick, Will Bowling on the mic too.
What's up?
Who is the most likely guy to be the best quarterback out of this group 5 years from now?
Best quarterback?
5 years from now.
5 years from now. Who's the best quarterback out of this
group? 5 years
from
now? Mac Jones.
Mac Jones!
Here's why. He's going to be picked 15th by the New England Patriots, and he'll be the most successful quarterback five years from now.
That's a fair argument.
Okay, so
Trevor Lawrence is going to be towards the bottom of this, and so will Zach Wilson, even though I think he's got the highest ceiling.
I agree with that. I agree with that. I was going with Justin Fields, him going to San Francisco.
And I think you could make the same argument that with George Kittle and with all the pieces, with that defense getting healthy again, Justin Fields would be my second pick.
I like Justin Fields atop that group if he goes to San Francisco.
Yeah.
The thing I worry about with Justin Fields is the whole one read thing, because I know that was Ohio State's system. I get it, but this is a different deal in the NFL. And I think he'll have initial success, but I wonder if defenses figure him out and then he falls off. Like RG3 or something.
I think it happens that way. I think it happens that way. But I also think by year five, if we look at his total body of work, I think he has the most success. You can't.
That's why I for 4. Asked you to clarify by year five or in their whole career. In their whole career, it's Trevor Lawrence. I think by year five, it's Mac Jones.
No, I'm a guy that believes, man, you are who you are. And Jacksonville, regardless of who they bring down there, is who they are.
I don't know if he'll still
is
be
who
there.
They are. Does that make sense?
Yes, it makes sense. Everybody knows what you're talking about.
That they is who they are.
He's such a winner, though.
They thought we were, or they were. What are we doing?
I mean, we're here.
Most likely to not be that guy is probably Trey Lance, right? Because we just don't know.
I like him, too, though.
Yep.
I
find myself really liking a lot of these guys, a lot of this group.
Yeah,
I don't like anybody beyond them.
Odds are one will be good.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah.
I mean, odds are zero of them will be good, and Kyle Trask in the second or third round will be the one that ends up being good if the trends continue. I'm not actually predicting.
Not according to Greg Cosell.
Yeah, no, he's not going to be good. unless he has Kyle Pitts with him. I'm just saying that if the trends continued, it would be somebody in the second or third round.
All right, Trash Talk Friday. We're going to do it, assuming we can get our phones going.
We're going to get them going, people.
If not, we're going to push it back, and we'll continue to have fun. We definitely will get to the messages coming through on the video feed, which is 104.5 The Zone TV. You need to find that. We've tweeted it. The Zone has tweeted it. You can find it. We'll be right back. Brent Doherty, Ron Slay, in Fort Don Davenport. This is 3HL.
You know you want to listen to Blaine and Mickey.
Come on.
Blaine and Mickey, Monday afternoon, 1 to 3 on 104.5 The Zone.
Some things are just true. Like Geico makes it easy to save on boat insurance. And also, buying a boat is way more fun than buying a goat.
Hey, Sam, nice boat.
Oh, thanks. Hey, I heard you were getting one.
No, I actually said I was going to buy a goat.
And,
Switch to Geico, and you could save hundreds on boat insurance. It's just true.
Ferguson Facility Supply is putting safety first with products like the E-Mist, which is an electrostatic disinfecting mister, and they have several forms of this. The handheld, which you can clean your office with real quick with PPE products, and then the backpack, you can clean a little more of a larger area. Then you can go warehouse with some of this stuff too. The E-Mist patented application system, 360-degree sanitation, allowing more coverage, less waste, and better results. No proprietary chemicals are needed, which is cool. And 1 gallon of solution can clean 54,000 square feet. 54,000 square feet, which obviously cuts labor and solution costs by 45%. Ferguson, one of the nation's top providers of maintenance, repair, and operations products for a variety of facilities, from multifamily hospitality, assisted living, schools, and more. Create a safer workspace with Ferguson. I was down there a couple months ago, saw some demonstrations of all these products. You need to check them out with their PPE line. Call Ferguson today at 888-242-6595. Call Ferguson today, 888-242-6595.
In the market for a late model pre-owned vehicle but don't want to deal with the hassle of traditional dealerships? My name is Tom Seifert, and I founded Genesis Auto Brokers over a decade ago to offer a better way to purchase your next pre-owned vehicle. As a licensed dealership, simply tell us what you're looking for, and through dealer-only auctions, we'll find the exact car to fit your needs and budget. At Genesis Auto Brokers, you'll save time, money, and hassle. Visit us at genesisautobrokers.com to start the easiest pre-owned car buying process in Middle Tennessee. That's genesisautobrokers.com.
Come to Dodge Chrysler Jeep Ram. That's where you need to go to get that next new vehicle. Get it done this weekend. Maybe you've been thinking about it for a while. Now is the time. Go see my friends at Gupton Dodge Chrysler Jeep Ram, about 30 minutes from downtown Nashville. Take 24 West to exit 35, straight shot to Springfield, Tennessee. 3450 Tom Austin Highway. That's where you'll find the best car, truck, SUV, or Jeep buying experience you've ever had. Check them out, 3450 Tom Austin Highway, and get online right now and check out the inventory, GuptonMotors.com. All of the dealership information is there as well. That's GuptonMotors.com. If you're out looking around dealership to dealership, make sure you include these guys. You'll be so glad that you did. Just go up and see them, take your test drive, ask your questions. You'll go inside. They'll help make the numbers work. It'll be that easy. 3450 Tom Austin Highway. Tell them Brent sent you. That's Gupton Dodge Chrysler Jeep Ram.
If you're thinking about selling your home this spring, now is the time. Hi, this is Mark Spain. When it comes to selling your home, experience matters. The Wall Street Journal ranks Mark Spain Real Estate number one in the United States for closed homes for the third year in a row. And when you call us, we respond fast. You can sell your home hassle-free and skip the constant cleaning and repairs and all the stress. With that guaranteed offer from Mark Spain Real Estate, you can receive an all-cash offer and close in as little as 21 days. Trust me, I've been in business for over 25 years and served over 25,000 homeowners, and I know what matters most, a quick sale and maximum profit. One of our clients, Chris, said, Mark Spain Real Estate made selling our home so easy and stress-free with their guaranteed offer program. We got an offer above market value, exceeding all of our expectations. Work with the most trusted team in real estate. Go to markspain.com to get a guaranteed offer on your home today and start packing.
855-299-SOLD.
Certain restrictions apply.
After two long years, Genesis Diamond Spectacular Spring Extravaganza is back. April 23rd through 25th. Three incredible days. Store-wide savings. Up to 35% off Genesis already guaranteed best price on engagement rings, earrings, bracelets, wedding bands, plus special financing.
This is the big one.
The one where they break all the rules. And Genesis GIA certified diamonds are marked down. Plus, top jewelry designers are flying in their entire collections. You've waited long enough. So don't miss this. April 23rd through 25th at Genesis Diamonds. Green Hills and Cool Springs. Unapproved credit.
You've waited 2 years for it, but the wait is almost over. Genesis Diamonds store-wide spring extravaganza is next weekend. April 23rd through 25th. This is the big one. A store-wide sale unlike any other. Extra savings up to 35% off. They're already guaranteed best prices on virtually everything. Rings, earrings, bracelets, pendants, colored gemstones, even GIA certified diamonds are on sale. Don't miss it. Best prices and special financing too. 3 days only. April 23rd through 25th. Only at Genesis Diamonds. Green Hills and Cool Springs.
The Lee Company is making it easier than ever to replace your heating and air conditioning system. Special finance plans available or $1,250 off select systems. Call 615-567-1000. Online at LeeCompany.com/promotions. Geico for your boat. See how much you could save at geico.com today.
Spring is the time to reorganize your life, and Artisan Custom Closets can help. Closets, garages, laundry rooms, and more. They can customize the perfect solution for your space. Go to artisancustomclosets.com or call 615-800-2199 to set up your free home consultation today.
Need to rent construction equipment, party tents and supplies, or a bounce house? Chief Rental will bring it to you and pick it up where and when you want it. Call Chief Rental at 754-RENT or order now at chiefrental.com.
From the 104.5 The Zone Traffic Center.
Reports of debris in the right lane at I-24 eastbound right before we get to Bell Road. And also downtown, we have an injury wreck at I-40 eastbound near the exit ramp to Charlotte Avenue. McGavick Pike at Briley Parkway dealing with a crash through there, and also dealing with a crash at Harding Place just east of Bellmead Boulevard. Be on the lookout for that. I'm Joshua McClay with traffic on your home for Titans football. 104.5 The Zone.
3HL 104.5 The Zone. Brent Doherty, Ron Slay hanging out with you. So, people that have heard Slay understand about the Boom Boom Room. Today we came up with a VIP Boom Boom Room by accident.
Yeah, sure did.
We almost, what else did we do today so far? We've got a long way to go, too, so hang on. There's going to be some more stuff. You almost gave away a barbecue recipe.
I almost did.
That you're working on.
And I'm glad I got my horses. Hold up, horsey. Hold up. Don't you go out there in this street.
We changed another word to undershirt.
Yes, we did. Yep. And yep. Mm-hmm.
After you had a talk with your son about that yesterday.
I sure did. LeRon knows it's an undershirt.
Yeah, and we've got the video feed up and running, man. You can get us on the Zone Facebook page. You can watch the show.
That's what I like, man. I like the interaction.
In living color. People. We're right here.
There's a lot of good comments on here. Love being able to see you guys. Thanks.
Yeah, that's Zena who says she came at it on the Facebook page. Love being able to see you guys. Carl on Periscope, watching on Periscope, just got back from Jump Zone Panama City. I played 5 minutes of jump dodgeball. I was done. Dude, playing dodgeball. Okay, look. So my 10-year-old's baseball team had a one-day tournament last week that got rained out on Saturday. Yeah. So as a part of the Sunday practice, the coaches decided, let's do a scrimmage. So they divided the team up, and then dads and brothers filled out the other spots.
Right.
So I'm in the outfield. The next day, I felt like I got hit by a car.
Playing dodgeball?
No, playing baseball.
Oh, this is baseball.
10-U baseball.
I saw you out there.
Oh, my
gosh. You were in right field.
I was in right field. I like that. I went to center field because right field was wet. I tried. I told my guy Kevin was next to me in center field. Yeah. I said, I'm going to throw this kid out. We had a guy on third and one out. I was like, if I get a fly ball, I'm throwing him out at home.
I'm gunning him.
And so I got a fly ball, and I went to crow hop to throw home, and it was wet in that outfield. I busted.
Oh.
I mean, busted. I had no idea where the ball went.
Wow.
So my kid was playing. I think he was playing first at this point. He was like, hey, Dad, the throw actually went home.
Yeah.
There were several bounces.
got it there, though. Not in the nick of time, but you got it there.
I'm just saying, like, grown A man playing kids' games, watch out.
Yeah.
Watch out.
It's real. It's so
now,
real.
Slay can go play basketball because that's what he does.
I can't wait to get out there.
Yeah.
I cannot wait. Yeah. And sometime when I come in, I get music playing like that. You know, when I walk in the gym, it's the big payback. I'm in. And that's how I feel when I come in there.
You should just walk in with one of those old school boom boxes. Boom, like Radio Raheem, and do the right thing.
Set that thing down. Let them know, here I am, baby. Here I am. Yeah, it's real.
Scott's on YouTube. He's watching on YouTube. He says, working from home today, enjoying the show, hoping for a secret rub recipe from Slay.
Well, Scott, I did. I just clicked on YouTube and I saw that. Scott, you know what? I'm going to have to charge for that, Scott. I just can't get it out of the Boom Boom Room, man. I'm going to tell you what to do. When I'm shutting the Boom Boom Room down, you come out, catch me taking some of the trash out, and I might whisper something to you. But I just can't get that out, Scott. I'm sorry, man.
Justin on Periscope, Boom Boom Sauce, is that what we're talking about?
Hey, yes. It's just been changed because where I got it from, my guy Zach, 1150 Bar and Grill, it's called the 1150 sauce, but it just has been changed to the Boom Boom Room sauce. So
you just changed the
name. Yeah, I'm taking platinum. Yeah, it had a regular tone to it. Now it's going platinum. So
Scott says I'll pay 0.0000001 Bitcoin.
Well, guess what? I have no stock. I won't no stock in that. So We got to come up with something else, Scott.
Bama JC says good to put faces with names.
Yeah, here, look, this face belongs on the Tizzoob.
I keep telling Will Bowling that we need to leave the feed open during breaks.
That's the best thing. Yeah, that's the best thing. You got to see us in break, clowning in break.
You want to do that for the next one?
We can, yeah.
Yeah, I'm going to tell you what. Y'all chime in. And y'all let us know what you want to see during the break. You know what I mean? If you want to see me do the typewriter, dance. The old school typewriter dance, the running man.
You talking about MC Hammer?
Yeah, that was my first concert. That's my guy. Yeah,
me too, at Starwood with Miss Chalet saying? And all those
Come
guys.
Come on, man.
I was there.
Yeah, it'll be the first live break.
How do we have the first concert? The same first concert?
That's dope. That's why. Because we're dope.
Oh, my.
We're dope.
There were a whole bunch of people on that card that night.
Yep. I had biking shorts on. What y'all think
That's
about
incredible.
That?
That's incredible. You remember
that? Yeah, with a big old box. My box was way okay. up here. Yep. Mm-hmm. Black biking shorts with the blue stripes on the right side.
I love it.
Yeah, it was real, man. Yeah.
Y'all with the box, too?
Little Big Slay. I was Little Big Slay at that time. I was probably about 11 or 12 years old,
was
too.
Was that Kid or Play that had the big box?
Kid. And I cut mine down because they kept saying Eraser Head after House Party came out.
Eraser.
Cut mine down, and then I went with the slope, the like Gumby slope in the front.
Yeah.
You have the comb sticking up?
Nah, I couldn't, I had no reason I didn't have it.
Kid and Play did that dance move that everybody tried to do, and it like, if you were me, you would like break your leg if you really tried to do it. They would lock their hands and then
and jump
through their hands like that.
That's what I'm doing at the break. I'm doing it at the break.
All right, coming up next.
Got about 10 minutes.
Will drives Ron to the hospital following trying to jump through his hands.
Yeah, Brent goes solo.
Next on 3HL, 104.5.
I love it, man. So, Trash Talk Friday. Kevin Mumfrey tells me, and I always think when I see Kevin, I think about Jerry Mumfrey, who was a really average Astro and Brave. There we go. We cross over there, Will, back in the day. Jerry Mumfrey. Kevin says that the phones work.
Hey.
He said he can't screen them, which means I got to take you live.
So people be kept. This is 104.5 The Zone 3HL. This ain't the Boom Boom Room. It's a shade of it. This ain't the Boom Boom. This is not. So you got to let you people know it. This ain't the Boom Boom Room. Don't come here with that mess.
When do you go live with the Boom Boom Room? Is there a set schedule? Just do it when you want
to
do it?
I know. I try to go every other Sunday when sports slows down. So it's slowing down. So I got Chris Lofton on this week. Chris Lofton shares some good stories, too. So
cold-blooded, that guy.
Man,
Maysville,
dude, man.
Kentucky.
Oh, my gosh. Hey, man.
You and him are like the two best players that didn't play in
the NBA. Didn't make it. Yeah, two players that didn't make
it. Both of you would make
it
now.
Yeah, that's the wildest thing.
Right?
Look at the game where we went from being – he had the problem of being a tweener also.
Yeah.
You know, between the point guard and the two.
And he wasn't a point guard. He wasn't quick enough.
Exactly.
Yep.
So
now – he was a shooter.
All of a sudden, we get to the point in the game. Now we call it positionless basketball.
Grayson Allen has a career. He scored 30 the other night.
Come on, man.
Chris
Lofton is the – I'm hot at it, Chris.
Chris
Lofton, I'm hot.
The reason why I wore 5 as a kid and everything was because Chris Lofton was my favorite.
He was so
– like any sport.
Amazing.
I was shooting fadeaways on the driveway with nobody guarding me because Chris Lofton.
And then my man played an entire season with cancer and didn't tell
anybody. Cancer.
Yeah.
Didn't tell anybody.
Yep.
Bruce Pearl finally said, y'all need to know what he's been dealing with.
You've got a generation of Tennessee fans that, and myself included in this, that love Tennessee basketball so much more and are as big on Tennessee hoops as they are Tennessee football, because that's growing up.
Mm-hmm.
That was the top 10 team
I
was watching
like,
more than football.
It's like Fulkerson's message, like growing up as a kid in Kingsport.
Those are all the kids I looked up to.
Yeah, Tyler Smith.
He mentioned Tyler Smith and Wayne Chisholm, didn't mention Ron Slay.
Yeah, we need to go at
him about that.
I remember you playing, but Folky and I are the same age, and mm-hmm. we were real little.
Mm.
We were real little.
You're wrong.
Well, I had an impact on little kids too, Will. You should have been
you
one
did?
Of those little kids.
No, you did. I'm sitting right here to confirming that.
Hey, man, I tell you what, though, looking at it, I forgot what I was going to say about Folky. Just looking at it, I'm just.
I thought his message. I haven't retweeted. I'm going to retweet it. I thought his message was on point. I mean, Ooh. just telling the story of how much he loved Tennessee basketball. And what did we say in the moment?
Mm-hmm.
He's not going to want to go out like that. Yep. And that was part of his message, was leaving the floor against Florida for the last time.
Yep.
I think that was a big part of it.
It was, man.
So,
it was.
You know, the question is, you know, how do you see Tennessee's rotation with Folky? And now you've got the four-star guy, which was the highest-rated post player Rick Barnes assigned at Tennessee. Then you get the five-star guy yesterday. And somebody put six man.
Yeah.
Vescovi going to be six man.
Yeah.
Yep.
And he's going to be a good one.
Listen, man.
Victor Bailey Jr. is a six man, too.
Is they've got I forgot. I'm thinking he's gone.
About him too.
They've got three six man.
I know.
They got like a seventh man and an eighth man.
Listen, man. Okay. All right. Here we go. Let's get to it. The depth on this team. Like we were talking about it last year. Like this is depth right here. If these young guys come along as they should, I do. We expect Hadley. Hatfield. Yeah, we expect him to get out there and play immediately. Mayshak to play immediately. Kennedy Chandler to play immediately. You still expect guys like VBJ. I forgot all about him, man. Olivier Kamwa, you forget about him. Like,
this is the kind of roster that will keep, like,
this is
they'll
nine
run
deep.
Over 100 points a
yeah,
lot.
This because, is
because
nine
they,
deep.
Like, they'll take people out, but they're still putting really talented players in.
And they're athletic.
Here's the thing, though, Ron, and you know this. People are going to be like, y'all with this Tennessee talk, they were supposed to be great last year. They're not going to be good, blah, 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 all that.
Yep. And it's easy. We point at, name the point guard we had, and name a system in Rick Barnes' career that has done well without a point guard. I want you to go all the way back to Clemson. My guy, Terrell McIntyre, we're going to get him on the show. A killer. We talk about Randolph, how cold Randolph Childress was. Terrell McIntyre was serious. He leaves there. Daniel Booby Gibson.
Yeah.
DJ Augustine. TJ Ford. Mm-hmm. The list goes on and on, man. Like, you got to have that point guard. We got one. Sets up a lot of different things. And then you got the kid Powell coming from Auburn who was able to run point when Sharif Cooper was out and did a really good job.
He's a lot like Vescovi. A shooter that can also run point.
There you go.
Yeah.
There you go.
But he's better.
And don't forget about Josiah Jordan James in this whole mix. This whole mix. Don't forget about him. Like, this is 9 to 10 deep for real.
Josiah Jordan James is going to be like Uncle JJJ.
Yeah.
He's going to be the uncle.
And see, that's the thing,
he's
Brent.
The guy. I think he loves that, too.
The difference with last year was a lot of inexperience. Mm-hmm. You come back to this year, automatically you got experience. You bring back Chris Winkie, who's focusing.
We talked about this the other day while Brent was gone with Don, too, that John Fulkerson needs a point guard that's going to force him to basketball. Because John Fulkerson's not going to sit on the low block and get that low post position like Grant Williams and demand the basketball.
No, he's not
assertive of a player.
He flashes and then goes.
And he's not as strong of a rebounder either. Right. And now you're gonna hole up that part of that gap in his game with Idu and Huntley Hatfield.
Yep. Yeah, you look at it. When did we say he was thriving? When Keon was at the point and pushing it, and he was hitting them running. Now imagine you got a guy that's going to command six eyes on him coming down the floor every single time in Kennedy Chandler. Opens Fulky up. Oh, man. Then
you're really excited over
it. No, I'm really hyped over
this. It's the most balanced really team hype. Rick Barnes has had in Tennessee.
Come on.
Last season's team might have been more talented. That's not even maybe true.
Didn't have
anymore.
Enough shooters, though.
It wasn't balanced enough.
Yep.
It was guard.
He hadn't even mentioned the Powell kid from Auburn.
Didn't even mention him.
44%, which would have led the team.
Come on now.
Tennessee was heavy at the 2 and the 3 last year. Didn't have enough at 1, 4, and 5.
Yes, sir.
In order to get the most out of the guys they had at the 2 and 3. That's not going to be the case as much anymore.
Vandy at Tennessee. Baseball, huge series this weekend. Will Bowling just showed us the line that the students have formed like noon today.
I'm impressed.
Trying to get in. I heard Josh Heupel was trying to get some seating cleared for the football team so they could get over there. Tennessee wearing the ice whites tonight and Vanderbilt wearing the black pinstripes. This is going to look good. 6 o'clock first pitch. Josh Heupel throwing out the first pitch.
Hey.
The worst news for Tennessee in that series is that Vandy lost a series last weekend.
I know. Everybody's saying that. Yeah,
they are not going to lose two straight series.
When you were playing, did you think about that? Like, if Kentucky rolled in having lost two in a row, would you rather them come in having won, like, eight in a row?
I'd rather them come in off winning a big game.
Yeah.
You know, you just get the momentum off of it. It's just part of it. And I hated rolling into them when they lost two in a row or something. Like, ooh.
Tennessee's legit. Kumar Rocker's not having two straight bad outings. Mm. It's not going to happen.
So what
say bad outing? He struck out 12. He gave up three bombs, but he struck out 12.
And this Tennessee lineup is as good as Vanderbilt. And Liam Spence is the SEC player of the year so far. He's got a on base percentage 25 points higher than anybody else in the SEC. As I go into the weeds on Tennessee baseball, which expect to do today. Sorry, keep inserting myself.
That's cool.
While you're here, Nashville SC first home game tomorrow.
Mm-hmm. Tomorrow night, 7:30, and it's a huge rivalry from the USL days. So for the casual Nashville sports fan that is going to check out NSC, doesn't know what it's about, wants to get in on that. Nashville SC and FC Cincinnati were two of the biggest teams in the United Soccer League.
Wow.
That's where NSC started 3 years ago.
Wow.
So
what about the soccer podcast? What do you got going there?
I'll get there. One second.
Teaser.
If you're going to give me the mic, I'm going to take it.
Teaser.
Yeah.
Might have some sponsorship information. You might
Cincinnati in due time. Cincinnati. Gosh, what's
like with, how he just points at me?
What's with Brent and giving away announcements? I'm not ready to give away yet.
I told you stop it, Brent. You guys,
I'm like the Beastie Boys. I let it flow. I let myself go slow and low. That is the tip. Oh, except I don't go slow. I go really fast.
So Cincinnati had, I believe, they averaged about 25,000 people at their minor league. Minor league's not the right word. Okay. Lower level team.
Congratulations.
And
to
so
them.
they were in the arena of being awarded an MLS team. And Nashville, who had just started playing in this lower league, had a quarter of those fans. Nashville was awarded a team before Cincinnati was, despite the fans that Cincinnati had. That Nashville hadn't had yet.
Screw Cincinnati.
So yeah, it's nasty natty.
They will bring a lot of people. They hate Nashville Soccer Club, and it's the first time these two teams have played in MLS. FC Cincinnati is the worst team in the league, and it's not close.
Do they say, really? Hey, who day also?
I don't know.
That'd be interesting. They
also are copying the Saints, just like their football team, apparently.
See there? I went with that one time.
I went to that game this past fall, too, and it was
– okay. Well, what about the podcast?
The Nashville Soccer Show official announcement coming soon. It is on the way back. Brent,
I cannot say things that
are not done yet.
Hey, man, Why not?
Because
you speak them into existence.
There is a process.
There you go. You want the ink to drop, Will.
Good Lord.
But all Brent sees when he's running the break is he sees you pointing up. And he says, just keep lobbing the ball out of bounds. You got to go up there and get it one time, Will. You keep on throwing you the lob. You got to dunk it. At least catch it and come
you
down.
You sound like Buck from 10 to 1.
The coach left the building. He's not here.
Yeah, we just do what we want in there.
We'll see.
There's literally no one in the building except for us four.
It's coming soon. Myself and Davey Shepherd will be talking to you on the 104.5 The Zone airwaves coming up very, very soon.
Let me ask you guys a question because you guys have been to baseball games.
Yep.
Going back to Tennessee and Vanderbilt real quick. How much of an impact does the crowd have at baseball games?
I think it's the number one heckling sport.
Probably true.
We talked about that, especially
in Tennessee.
Yeah,
it is now.
They're making people cry up there.
I love that.
I mean, you got the LSU coach bitching and whining and moaning and all this. I'm like, hey, win a game. You got swept. Shut up.
Right. Hush and go home.
That's right.
It's a shame it's not a full capacity because they really would be adding seating into there.
Yep, they would.
Dope,
let's do this. Let's take a break. Jayson Swain, CEO of the Swain event, coming up next. Stay tuned. 3HL, 104.5 The Zone.
Get the lowdown on the hottest team in the NHL right here. The best Preds coverage can be found on 104.5 The Zone.
Best soccer coverage can be found, too, if Will Bowen would tell you about it. Details, man, details. Fast Wi-Fi, stay tuned. Will's, I'm just going to start calling him Stay Tuned. Will Bowen's new nickname is Stay Tuned. Yeah, fast Wi-Fi, use it to connect to just about everything, which means having fast Wi-Fi matters a lot. That's why Xfinity offers gig speed Wi-Fi, the fastest Wi-Fi you can get. It's important if you want to watch the show as well. You need me and Big Slay and Don and everybody involved in 3HL in HD, and that's a big deal. It's a big deal for streaming big games, having big meetings, making big plans. It's a big deal for families with one kid, maybe two kids, maybe three kids, especially if there's one kid who has enough devices for 10 kids. Know what I'm talking about. It's a big deal for gamers who are streaming while someone else is posting about their virtual spin class. And yet, it's also a big deal for a quiet Friday night in because fast Wi-Fi makes everything better. Check out the new gig speed Wi-Fi or any other speed options. Get started with Xfinity Internet with up to 25 megabits per second download speed for $25 a month for 12 months. Click, call, or visit a store today. Gig Wi-Fi requires gig internet and compatible gateway. Actual speeds vary and are not guaranteed. Advertised offer requires paperless billing and auto pay ends May 20th, 2021. New performance starter internet customers only. Equipment taxes and fees are extra and subject to change after the term regular rates apply.
Some things are just true, like Geico makes it easy to save on boat insurance. And also, a long boat ride is way better than a long car ride.
Are we there yet?
No, not yet.
Awesome! More boating, more boating.
Switch to Geico, and you could save hundreds on boat insurance. It's just true.
We all know that Mr. Good Roof is your favorite roofing company. But did you know that Mr. Good Roof also does windows? Mr. Good Roof offers a variety of replacement windows to choose from that are guaranteed to satisfy your design taste or maybe your significant other's picky design taste. And they'll save you money on your heat and air bill, too. From roofs, windows, to gutters, even siding, Mr. Good Roof has you covered. Now, let's also talk about your roof. When was the last time you were up there? You know what kind of shape it's in, do you? What if you need a repair or even a replacement? What if you got storm damage? Don't trust one of the door knockers. Call Mr. Good Roof, a locally owned family business that Middle Tennesseans have trusted for years. Mr. Good Roof is licensed and insured, and they always have a supervisor on site in case you have questions. Visit Mr. Good Roof showroom in Hendersonville or call them at 615-824-8100.
Hey folks, this is Paul Winkler. In my over 30 years as a financial planner, I've seen a lot of mistakes when it comes to planning for retirement. Many times people just put money in their target date funds at work, which is kind of a one-size-fits-all type of investing process, or they don't do anything or do too little because they don't know what to do. They might use Roth IRAs or Roth 401ks when pre-tax investments would be a better fit based on their tax circumstances, or vice versa. Sometimes people buy individual stocks thinking, well, I'm taking more risk, I should get more return. Well, why would a company want to pay you more money to use your money? And finally, and this is a big one, where people will work with somebody from a big investment firm, a bank, or a mutual fund company, not thinking about the fact that the advisor works for that company rather than representing them. Think about it this way. You might spend as much time in retirement as you did in work. It takes planning to be successful. To find out what makes us so different, go to our website at paulwinkler.com. You can set up a free 15-minute phone call or even a meeting right there, paulwinkler.com.
I'm Mick McGoran from One Hour, and spring is the best time to rejuvenate your AC with a maintenance plan I call...
Mick's Trifecta.
Wait a minute, Ryan. Naming it after me?
Of course, Mick. Your spring AC maintenance package protects your system three ways.
I don't like to draw attention to myself.
That's crazy. You're a natural.
You think so?
The camera loves you, Mick.
This is radio, Ryan.
So tell us why Mick's Trifecta is such a great service.
First, your system is completely cleaned on the inside. Perfect.
Then what?
Every moving part lubricated so it runs smooth. Perfect.
And then?
Your system is tuned and calibrated to factory specs. Perfect.
Running at maximum efficiency.
And all this for only...
$133.
Okay, Ryan, I guess we can call up Mick's Trifecta.
OneHourMick.com.
Always on time, or you don't pay a dime.
Make your appointment for Mick's Trifecta.
Guaranteed three ways.
Good idea on the name, Ryan. Maybe I'll keep you around a bit longer.
Independently owned and operated.
Are you in the market for a garage, storage shed, or pole barn? Enter Affordable Building Concepts. These guys have been serving the Nashville area for 20 years and have an A-plus rating with the Better Business Bureau. They are licensed, bonded, and insured, so rest easy. Need a carport, new fence, deck, or a patio cover? Call them for your free on-site consultation. 615-594-5587. Or visit affordable-buildings.com. 615-594-5587. Affordable Building Concepts. Concepts, your backyard builders.
Geico for your boat. See how much you could save at geico.com today.
This is for the men who never settle. The ones who believe only quitters end a game in a tie. The type of guys who choose the bar with the biggest TVs to overcompensate for theirs at home. This is the Lodge mentality. This is Twin Peaks.
From the 104.5 The Zone Traffic Center.
Brought to you by Napa Auto Parts. Whether it's offering curbside or next day delivery for online orders on over 160,000 parts or getting involved in their local communities, when it comes to serving you, Napa's motor never quits. That's Napa know-how. Still getting reports of debris in the right lane southeast of town at I-24 eastbound right before you get to Bell Road, as well as a crash in McGavick Pike at Briley Parkway. Also be on the lookout for a wreck at Gallatin Pike at Hickory Street. I'm Joshua Clay with traffic on your home for Titans football. 104.5 The Zone.
HL 104.5 The Zone. We left the feed up during the break. Crossley's over here warming up. I don't know what he's doing. He's like, it's like you're getting ready to fight somebody. Like, you're in the corner. Like Rocky. He's fighting old time, he said. During the feed, like, he wants to do the kid and play dance, which is all we're talking about, because there are a lot of younger people that don't know what the hell that is. But basically, if you would just lock your fingers, and then you got to almost go like you're sitting with your foot over your knee, and then you got to jump through your arms. He says he's got it. All right, this is happening on the video feed. What was that? Did you pop something?
Everything also okay in there?
Also, what is this alarm that keeps going off? Are we under siege?
It's just like if anyone's watched 24 in CTU Los Angeles is the fictional like FBI place.
Yeah, I really think
have,
so.
This is the ringtone they have in CTU in 24, and it makes me think of Jack Bauer is going to come in trying to defuse a bomb in the studio.
Yeah, like Jack Phil Valentine Bauer about to run through here or something. I mean, what's going on? I don't know. Brent, did you do it? I missed it.
You missed it. Everybody missed it.
Oh, my God.
Everybody missed it. And guess what? You only get that once every 2 months, people.
I have good news for you, by the way, Brent, real quick, as I just turn my mic on again. I actually am – Brent's busy. He's not even listening to me.
I'm trying to get to Swain, man. Swain's over in Knoxville wondering where we are.
Brent, I actually am okay to make official announcements, programming announcements.
See?
I said stay tuned. Here we are.
Okay, stay tuned.
I had to shoot a text. The Nashville Soccer Show.
Listen.
You had to confirm with somebody higher up.
I'm a rule follower by nature.
No.
Will takes me to another level.
No.
You had to shoot a text.
I'm not
going to
tell people that my show is back on Tuesday if it's not back on Tuesday. I don't want to mislead the thousands and thousands of people that are tuning in across Nashville, Tennessee.
You tell them it's back, and then, you know, when it's not back, you tell them when the real day is.
Next Tuesday night, the Nashville Soccer Show returns to 104.5 The Zone at 9 p.m. We are pleased to be sponsored by Fat Bottom Brewery, who is going to partner with us. Got a lot of great sponsors, some giveaway, a ticket giveaway to tell you about soon. It's going to be.
See, how hard was that?
Yeah, I didn't know about all this until I look at my phone and Davey Shepherd's.
I knew about it. How did you not know about it?
Okay, well, I didn't know specifics, and he's already put an Instagram post up of, hey, like this post, and you'll be entered to win two tickets to NSC in Montreal.
Hey.
It's unbelievable. Anyway. The slander I get on these airwaves recently is preposterous.
Rob said I was close to him. I couldn't play. He saw it. Thanks, Rob Midget.
If you did it, you did it fast. Like, there was some quick twitch involved in that.
Yeah, I get it done. I'm like Batman.
Ron Slay's motto, I get it done.
Here's also where we are. People are showing us, like, shooting us pictures of them grilling. So, like, we've got all kinds of amazing food in our timeline now.
Yes, it is. It's getting real.
I'm telling you.
It is getting real out here, people.
All right, we're trying to get to Swain. I don't know if the phones work. This is where we are today. It's an unbelievable.
It has to be
calamity going on.
Because what Mike said, I think it's very appropriate that you put the auditioning couch behind Mr. Boom Boom Room itself. You are right. Because sometimes, if this mic could stretch out long enough, guess what? Guess where I would do this show from?
The couch.
The couch.
Yeah. Yep. So Buck Rising, if you missed it yesterday, Buck Rising wanted to move the couch that used to sit behind me and him. We used the same mic. And he moved it yesterday, put it behind Dawn, which she was like, he called in because, you know, we were talking about him and people started texting him. And so he called in. I'm like, what do you want? And he's like, what do you mean? I got people telling me I need to call you. What do you guys want? And Dawn says, look, you're the new guy around here.
You can't just move stuff.
You can't move furniture. You need to ask for permission.
It's true.
Is what she said.
I like that, Dawn. Put the smack down, Babs.
Let's just go ahead and ask the room. Is everybody, as Fred Durst once said, in agreement that we need to ask Don for permission to do basically anything?
Oh, yeah, you ain't got no choice. Unless you want to mess with the wrath.
I mean, Will Bowling just went through this.
I was on Buck's side on this until he went on his show this morning and said, it's actually Will's fault. And I'll say this because he's not here to defend himself. Because he said,
this
just
is going to make
there.
Him call, though.
I don't know.
He's like Batman. We're putting the bat signal out.
He blamed it on me. And it's not my fault. It's his fault because he said, all right, when are we moving that couch? I said, we are. I wanted to put it in the green room where the putting green is.
Yeah, but then you've got to turn the couch to get it through the door, and that door's heavy, so then that's a whole other thing.
That's fine.
I like the couch in here.
I love the couch in here. I lay down on the couch.
I do, too. I will not let Buck throw it away because that's going in my apartment if it's thrown out of
Buck, let me see you try to throw that couch away. Let me see. It's me and you, Buck. How about that?
Ron said, come and see me.
Yeah, that's right. You know it, too.
Hey, so as we can't get any guests on, apparently, the WNBA draft was yesterday. For those that don't know, I didn't know until I saw on Twitter the salary projections for this. And I shot you this list, Ron, because it's low, man. And you wonder why a lot of these ladies go overseas.
Mm-hmm.
Like Alicia Clark, who is unbelievably skilled and talented and an awesome person, by the way. They go overseas because that's where the money is. So they love their sports overseas, right? I mean, you played there. Like, there's a market over there.
Yes, it is.
So I looked at SpotTrack put this out. Mike Jannetty put this out. Projected salary, number one overall pick, $220,000. Which is a nice chunk to a lot of people. But she's the best at what she does this year.
Right, right.
$220,000.
That's tough.
And they're on ESPN, right? So what is the TV contract?
Mm-hmm. A lot of that needs to kick in. I think CBS ABC does a tremendous job.
ABC, yeah.
Yeah, does a tremendous job with it with the NBA. But something has to trickle down to them, man. Like
Renia Davis at number nine, $202,000. So then you go second round, 193. So it's pretty consistent from pick one to first pick of the second round. It really doesn't matter.
See, it's twofold for me. One is for them to be affiliated with the NBA, and you see those salaries, and then you look at the WNBA salaries, it's laughable. Like, that's ridiculous. Then you look at it on the other end, the NBA put butts in seats. And
the TV contracts
that really helps.
All of those things. Yeah. So, I mean, ultimately you got to figure out a way to make the WNBA more popular.
You
need more ratings.
That's always been a struggle. It's always been a struggle.
But yeah, that blew my mind. Like, I didn't know what I thought I knew that some of the salaries were lower, obviously. But I didn't think the top end player made 220.
But let me tell you what they'll do overseas. They'll give you a contract to not go back over.
So there's like a rider on the contract where you can make more money to stay there.
Yeah, yeah. Or just sit that season out.
How competitive is it over there?
Very competitive.
Okay.
Volleyball. Everything, yeah. They get after it. Well, I know in Italy for sure. They get after it.
Italian volleyball?
Yeah.
You can probably get some ratings in America on that deal.
Them games be hype too, dude. It shocked me. I'm looking at it like, I understand soccer. I understand about men's basketball. Yes. But
soccer's boring though. Italian women's volleyball?
Yeah. That'll do it.
You could probably throw that on ESPN too and outdo some truck race, right?
You will be able to. Yep. You will be able to.
I'd rather watch volleyball than the NBA.
Okay, there we go. I will not. I will not.
I was starting to say that, then I remembered who was sitting next to me.
Yeah, I let Babs do it yesterday. Enough is enough.
This is what I'm trying to tell you, Will. That was a great line by you, and it led to some comedy on the show. Let it fly, dude.
Let it roll.
You said I almost didn't say it because of who's sitting across from me. No, you be you. Let it fly.
But think about it, though, Will. Stuff that's going to fly back. So if I just launch across,
after what Buck has flying at me from 10 to 1, he's bullied me into not speaking.
So the way the room sits, just to kind of paint this image in your mind as you listen.
You can watch.
You can watch, but we're all in different boxes, so you really can't get a feel. I'm in the middle, okay? Yep. Will, as I look toward Kevin, who is producing the show through, I don't know, like 8 sheets of glass. It'd be hard to get, get in there. It probably is, which is probably good for us because we go on so many tangents. Producers always want to kill us.
Yeah, we're late right now, so yeah.
As I look at Kevin, to my left is Will Bowling. To my right is Ron Slay. So they're across from each other. And the way the studio is, I mean, what do we got here? Like a rhombus-shaped studio table? And then it's raised because there are computer screens inside from the desk part of the table to another desk part of the table. So one day, Don Davenport climbed across from Slay's seat over to JT, who was getting ready to leave. The next day was his last day, and Don was climbing across the table to make sure that we couldn't do something. Keep JT. And I'm looking at her going, what are you doing? Like, something bad is going to happen.
I wish that had been on 104 about this on TV.
Not to disrespect Don, but you're too old to be doing this, man.
Must see TV.
You had a child
there
10 months ago. Get off the table. That's tough. All right, here's what we're going to do. We're going to try to take phone calls in the next hour, and we're going to do Trash Talk Friday.
Who knows?
So if you want to load them up, I'll go to you. We won't process the call. We'll just take you live, and we'll have a lot of fun with it. I'm quite sure Ron Slay has some trash talk. I do, too. That's coming up in the next hour. All right? Stay tuned. 3HL is on 104.5 The Zone.
Buck Rising defends John Robinson. He dishes the facts.
It's not that I'm here to blindly defend John Robinson. I'm here to defend John Robinson because John Robinson's track record demands that I defend John Robinson. These are just the facts.
Buck Rising, Monday, 10 a.m. to 1 p.m. on 104.5 The Zone.
This is Tiki Barber with a CBS Sports Minute, sponsored by NetSuite by Oracle. Receive your free product tour right now at netsuite.com/golf. The NCAA's Division I Council finally approved the long-expected change to college transfer rules. Football, basketball, baseball, and men's hockey athletes now have the right to a one-time transfer without having to sit out a season. This is a win for athletes, especially if they find themselves in untenable situations. But there are many downsides, including the academic toll that is bound to occur, and the fact that kids aren't learning the value of persevering through difficult situations. Perhaps the biggest unintended consequence will trickle down to high schools. There are a limited number of scholarships for the millions of high school athletes in this country. And if schools begin reserving some of those scholarships for potential transfers, high school students lose big. Nobody wants to see that. Maybe this isn't such a good idea. I'm Tiki Barber.
At Napa, we keep things moving. If it has wheels and an engine, we help keep it on the road. And if it's on the road, we have parts for it. And if you need a part, you can get it fast, like same-day pickup or next-day delivery fast. At Napa, when we're not thinking about cars, we're thinking about the people who drive them. Because when it comes to serving you and our community, our motor never quits. That's Napa know-how. Same-day pickup and next-day delivery available at participating stores and on in-stock items only.
If I'm not commuting anymore, where do I really want to live?
While you handle life's questions, Merrill Guided Investing helps you manage your portfolio and invest for your next move. With the option to work with an advisor at a low cost and minimum. Merrill, a Bank of America company. Visit MerrillEdge.com/investing goals to get started today.
Investing involves risk. Merrill Lynch, Pierce Fenner, and Smith Incorporated, both a registered broker-dealer and investment advisor, member SIPC. Investment products are not FDIC insured or not bank guaranteed and may lose value.
We've all had that dream. Tie game. Bottom of the ninth, bases loaded. Oh, yes. Jump on FanDuel Sportsbook, and you get more than one shot to swing for the fences because FanDuel is now letting you place that first bet risk-free. That's right. New users get up to $1,000 back in site credit if your first bet does not win. It only gets better from there, too. Once you have an account, you'll get to access same-game parlay insurance all season long. That's up to $25 back in site credit each day if your same-game parlay bet falls one leg short. This way, you can combine multiple baseball bets for an even bigger bigger win. There's a reason FanDuel Sportsbook is America's number one sportsbook app. Super simple to use. They've got great odds on all these different betting markets. Jump in, download the FanDuel Sportsbook app, sign up with promo code DAWN to get in on all the baseball action. 21 and older and present in Tennessee. First online real money wager only for risk-free bet. Refund issued as non-withdrawable site credit that expires in 7 days. Restrictions apply. See sportsbook.fanduel.com for details. Gambling problem? Call the Tennessee Red Line 1-800-889-9789.
Everything these days claims to be smart, but that doesn't mean they always work smart. Like when the robot vacuum tried to inhale my foot, or when the dog food dispenser thought Fetch was underweight.
Dinner time.
One smart thing you can rely on is Pennington Smart Seed. It's so smart, it uses 30% less water year after year, and is guaranteed to grow. Pennington Smart Seed, real intelligent turf. Pennington Grass Seed is available at Walmart.
Hi guys, it's Andrew. Are you struggling with ED? Well, I have great news. Hillside Medical Clinic uses the most advanced form of acoustic wave therapy, clinically shown to open up and regrow blood vessels. We're finally treating the root cause problem of ED. No pills, no injections, and no surgery. Even Cambridge tested our technology and showed that it is highly effective. If you're struggling with ED and sick of the pills, call us right now for an unprecedented offer. We'll give you the initial medical assessment, exam, even the blood flow ultrasound, totally free. We'll also include a special gift proven to produce instant results in the bedroom. This is a $500 value, but it's totally free to those that call us in the next 2 minutes. Put a stop to your ED and get the intimacy back. Call Hillside Medical Clinic right now to qualify for this offer. 615-576-5000. That's 615-576-5000. Hillside Medical Clinic. 615-576-5000.
A reading from the Golden Oak Lending Book of Mortgage Lingo. What is Zipline? It's Golden Oak's fast and easy online mortgage tool that leaves you with more time to plan a family movie night.
I get to pick the movie.
And clean up the popcorn you weren't planning on sharing.
Okay.
At Golden Oak Lending, we speak mortgage and love translating it. Right now, rates are at a record low 1.875%. Visit goldenoaklending.com to use Zipline. NMLS 114937. 1.875% fixed. 2.913% APR. FHA 15-year mortgage with 20% equity and approved credit.
Hey, we get it. You don't want to be hearing a Progressive commercial right now, so let us tell you something you do want to hear. No one is funnier than you. People laugh just thinking about the things you've said. I'm laughing at one of them right now. Coworkers repeat your jokes at the office, but they're never as good as when you tell them, and shame on them for trying. There, don't you feel better? You'll also feel better knowing you could save when you bundle home and auto with Progressive. Although I'm sure you'd have a funnier way to say that. Progressive Casualty Insurance Company affiliates and other insurers. Bundle discount not available in all states or situations.
For the ones finding new ways to ensure the job always gets done. For the ones wearing many hats. For the ones who are hands-on, even from far away. And the ones keeping business moving forward. We are Grainger. Offering supplies and solutions for every industry, with 24/7 support and experienced staff at over 250 local branches. Call clickgrainger.com or just stop by. Grainger, for the ones who get it done.
At Progressive, we're making things even easier. We'll help you bundle your home and car insurance together so you can save on both. Learn more at progressive.com or 1-800-PROGRESSIVE.
What's going on, Titans fans? Let's have some fun by predicting who we think the Titans will be selecting in the first round of this year's draft. Take a tour of 104.5 The Zone's 2021 mock draft as each show predicts who they think the Tennessee Titans will select thanks to Chattanooga Whiskey. Which host made the right pick? Watch and listen as J-Mart and Ramon, Blaine and Mickey, 3HL, and myself, we break down our selections by going to 1045thezone.com/2021mockdraft. Then, tell us who you think the Titans will pick for a chance to win a prize pack thanks to Chattanooga Whiskey.
From the 1045 The Zone Traffic Center.
Brought to you by Smart Mouth, the only 24-hour mouthwash with twice daily use. Stay fresh out there with Smart Mouth Mouthwash, the only mouthwash that provides 24 hours of fresh breath with twice daily use. So whatever the day may bring, you can stay sunny with a side of fresh. Grab a bottle today, available wherever mouthwash is sold, or visit smartmouth.com. Crews are clearing up some debris down in Franklin. It's reduced down to one lane at I-65 southbound at Murfreesboro Road. Be on the lookout for that. And also, we have a stalled vehicle southeast of town blocking the right shoulder at I-24 eastbound right before you get to Bell Road. McGavick Pike at Riley Parkway, we also have a crash, as well as at Gallatin Pike at Hickory Street. I'm Joshua Clay with traffic on your home for Titans football, 104.5 The Zone.
From the Mark Spain Real Estate Studios, this is your Titans NFL Draft Station. WGFX Gallatin Nashville. Trending now at 104.5 The Zone.
Good afternoon, I'm Will Bowling. John Fulkerson is back, announcing on his Twitter account today that he will return for his sixth season of eligibility under Rick Barnes and the Tennessee Vols. Second-ranked Vanderbilt, third-ranked Tennessee this weekend in Lindsey Nelson Stadium on the Diamond. It's the first time ever that Vandy and Tennessee will face off as top five opponents in baseball. Nashville Soccer Club kicks off its second MLS campaign tomorrow night in Nissan Stadium. Kickoff is 7:30 against FC Cincinnati. And the Nashville Predators will look to bounce back from a 4-1 loss last night against the Hurricanes again tomorrow. Puck drops at 7. Breaking news at once on your home for the Titans and Vols. This is 104.5 The Zone.
The 3HL with Brent Doherty and Don Davenport.
HL 104.5 The Zone. It's time. Trash Talk Friday. Let it rip. Your least favorite player, your least favorite coach, maybe something you've been burning on for a little bit all week. Need to get it off your chest. You have that opportunity right now. Brent Doherty, Ron Slay in for Don Davenport, who is at Auburn. She will be on the sideline for the Auburn spring game, which I don't know. It's on SEC Network, ESPN.
Who cares?
I don't know about Auburn. Well, I mean, watch our buddy Don on the sideline.
No shot at Babs. Yeah, definitely. I don't want that Babs smoke, believe me. It's cool.
Nobody does.
I would like to announce.
You've got an announcement.
I've got an announcement.
Did you clear it through Will Bowling?
I wish I would clear it.
Is this a stay tuned thing that Will does?
No, I'm letting it rip. I am now, since we are on 104.5 TV on Facebook, Twitter, Twitch, Periscope, YouTube, what else, Will? Facebook. We're on all of that, 104.5 The Zone. And we can interact with you guys, and I'm interacting with some people. So now, after I did the kid and play and Rob Midget said it was close, yep, it was close, I am now taking dance requests on Fridays anytime I'm on 3HL.
What in the world?
You're taking dance requests? I'm taking dance requests, as you guys can see me. And they asked for the Carlton.
Nothing good can come from this. You're going to get hurt, dude.
I'm giving them the Carlton now.
You're doing the Carlton now? Yep. Wait, you better give people time to click over the video feed. I just tweeted the link.
Get on.
So tennis, let's see. There he is. There's Ron Slay. So YouTube, Periscope, Facebook, the Zone Facebook page, Twitter Live. Ron Slay is going to do the Carlton. You almost need the music, don't you? Oh my gosh.
Hey.
He's doing it.
Yeah.
I thought the couch was going to get in the way for a second.
Hey, man. Hey, I know how to work my area.
You kicked the wall.
Yeah, I have to get that one out of here. Do a little remodeling. It's the boom boom room, man. We do a little remodeling in here.
Oh, my. That was so funny.
Yeah.
There's a delay on the video feed.
I love
the audio.
It, too, because I like to watch myself, too, sometimes.
Were you watching yourself dance?
I was. You got to get your rhythm while you're watching. What?
He Hate V says, hit that Macarena with music while we're at it.
I was just about to read that. That's my guy right there.
That was out. Okay. Hey, Will.
Whatever V says goes in this.
Coming out the next break. Ron Slay does the Macarena.
We're taking requests. By the way, we're about an hour away from BP. Looks like Kumar Rocker is going tonight for Vanderbilt.
Kumar Rocker and Chad Dallas on the hill.
So I love that we're talking about this series. Two top five teams.
Dude, this is beautiful.
It's honestly.
By the way, Cooper Davis back in the lineup for Vanderbilt.
Just tune in for the antics. If you're not a baseball guy, it's just going to be entertaining to watch how these teams interact with one another. Tennessee's got a little bit of an edge to him under Tony Vitello. It's fun to watch.
Tim Corbin's just the best of the best. Yeah. You know what people tell me that aren't Tennessee fans? They're a bunch of a-holes.
That's what I like. The proper way to describe it.
I like that.
You said a little bit of an edge.
I was the Vanderbilt way of saying that. I was the more buttoned up way of saying that. Listen, Vanderbilt's not losing two series in a row, that's for sure.
Braves and Cubs, spoiler alert, Braves up 5-2.
That's right.
In the bottom of the ninth.
Will Smith on.
With one out. Will Smith.
Good. Yeah.
Hey.
There might be a Will Smith dance you could do. I don't know what it is. I mean, you just did the Carlton.
One point in the NLCS last year between the Braves and Dodgers, there was a batter named Will Smith and Will Smith, the Braves pitcher. It was Will Smith versus Will Smith.
There is a Will Smith on my kid's CPA middle school baseball team.
Really?
Shout out, Will.
First friends.
If you're listening.
He's a catcher and a pitcher.
I've been badgered on badgered.
People are going at you?
Yeah, somebody heckled me. And guess who it is?
Ramon Foster. How did I guess?
You got it. Man, these dance moves ain't nothing.
Oh, my. Why would you put yourself in the middle of that?
Ramon, you know what? Hey, man, it's me and you, dog. You know, it's me and you. Back patio, before we have our cigar and drink, it's me and you, one-on-one.
All right, so we're going to have a Ron and Ramon Olympics on 104.5 TV. We're going to have a cook-off.
Yep. And a dance-off. I'm and here for the Ron Slay Ramon Foster dance-off.
Maybe a game of horse is the tiebreaker. So we have three competitions. That way, we have something to break the tie.
I'm taking dance requests, and Ramon gets over here and talks bad about my dance moves. I can't believe it, man.
I thought you did a great Carlton.
Thank you. I'm not going to lie.
I would tell you if I didn't think that you did a good job.
And with no music, that was a cappella. Like, imagine if the music was going, I would have really
Did
went
you
off.
Have the music going on in your head?
In my head. Guess what I was at? Dun, 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 dun,
dun, dun. See, Will, usually I can do that to Dawn and make her do things like that. Just pulling the strings, man. I'm just like, I'm like the
puppet master,
the godfather with the puppets. Slay just went right into it.
Yeah, I want my strings pulled. Well, man, I'm Woody from Toy Story.
There you go. All right, so Macarena is coming up next. That's the
Macarena is coming out of the break.
Right, so Will Bowling is leaving the video feed up during the break, so I don't know what we do. I'm glad the audio wasn't up in the last break.
I feel like this is like the mom is gone and the kids can play.
Yeah, yeah. We would have entitled that part of the podcast "The Women of Portugal."
Dawn is very specific on not wanting to be on during break. So this is like,
well, she doesn't want to be on at all.
Darrington said the percolator.
Darrington Evans said
the percolator.
Yeah, see, you don't know about that, Will. That's before your time right this time.
Justin said the hammer dance, which used to be called the Chinese typewriter.
So did, yeah.
But now you just called it the typewriter, which is probably
guess what?
The equivalent of calling it a T-shirt.
Will has, yes. I mean, no, Brent has more room. So y'all got to let me know, typewriter or the Macarena coming back from
you? You got to do it behind me.
I'm moving it to Brent's, yep.
With Coach Mack in the background.
All right, yeah.
Trash Talk Friday. I was going to trash talk Vanderbilt, but here's the thing. I like the Vanderbilt baseball program.
They're a hard
I really can't trash
hard,
talk them.
Hard program to find anything negative.
Like, yeah. Hey, best baseball team in America, yeah. You suck.
Yeah.
But you really don't. Just keep doing what you do. I mean, like, what? You can't trash talk Vandy baseball. Although, as you said, the Tennessee fans and team will figure out a way. Now, Will Bowling is a trash talk master. He once made a tennis player cry.
That's really?
Cool. On the court.
One of my friends played for the Tennessee women's tennis team, and I made her opponent cry.
I
helped make her cry. There was a bad call that helped too, but me and my buddies, yeah.
That's what it's about, Will. That's what I'm talking about.
You should have talked to her after the game. You had a chance there.
I kind of had a thing with one of the other girls on the Wake Forest tennis team at one point too. So they were teammates. They were teammates at that point. Yeah. If you're not going to trash Vanderbilt baseball, I will.
Do it. I'm trying to figure out a way to trash talk Vandy baseball.
Since Tim Corbin took over at Vanderbilt,
here we go. Get him, Will.
Vanderbilt is 2-4. As a ranked team in series at Lindsey Nelson Stadium. They are 0 for their last three series as a ranked team and lost the lone ranked versus ranked series. So
see, those are numbers. They're... It's not trash talk.
Hey, I let the numbers speak for himself.
Vandy going down.
There's some trash
talk. You going down. I don't care nothing about that. Your record, Vandy boys, none of that. Boys to men up there on the hill. We ain't got nothing for no boys.
This is
bring your lunch
again.
Card. We back. Tennessee is back. We reincarnated Todd Helton.
This is Tony
all over the field.
Tony Vitello, who drives an orange.
Yeah, my bad. I killed
Todd Tony Vitello, who drives an orange Italian sports car around Knoxville.
Oh, there you go. Tim There's Corbin. The connection.
Really?
The Italian sports car. And we're drinking Pellegrino because Ramon Foster has got this like high class fridge.
What is this, man? In Italy, they call this acqua frizzante, and this is horrible.
That's my nickname in high school.
Frizzante? Aqua.
That's how I catch people off guard now, too. Is I just say, oh, yeah, that was my nickname in high school.
We are literally unexpectedly drinking Pellegrino in the studio.
It's terrible.
No, it needs vodka.
Dude, this is exactly.
Most things need vodka, bro.
It needs Tito's.
This is a happy hour.
I could trash talk some Pellegrino. Dang, hour, Ramon. Dude.
Come on, Ramon.
Ramon, get some working man's drinks in here.
Please.
Something with sugar.
He got it because Buck pressured him into it. Because Buck, that's all he does is
pressure people into doing things. It's all sparkling water and like.
I'm going to take all this and put it in the truck.
Diet grape soda with no sugar in
it? Yeah, come on. What is this? Yeah, and he knows better than that, too.
Do better, Ramon.
What if I go put that Kool-Aid?
I just trash talk Ramon.
There you go.
There you go. All right, your turn to trash talk. Trash talk Friday. I think Bama JC's on the line. We'll get to the phone calls when we come back. Jump on 615-737-1045. Let us have it. Let them have it. Let everybody have it. We'll be right back.
Get nonstop draft talk and coverage on the go. Download the 104.5 The Zone app and never miss a moment. It's NFL Draft Month on 104.5 The Zone.
Sports betting legal in Tennessee. And if you listen to the show, I already convinced Ron Slay what to do tomorrow night in a specific hockey game. Because there's a hockey team that hasn't beaten another hockey team all season long. They might have lost all five of them, which means they're due, which means the other hockey team is going to be favored. So you go money line and you win some serious ducats. That's my pick for the weekend. I'm shooting my shot now. I've been shooting my shot all day. Sports betting legal in Tennessee. Use these guys when you do it. Action247.com is the website. The only local sports book in Tennessee. The only legal local sports book in Tennessee. Get it done. Buy Tennessee is for Tennesseans. The apps are down. Download those and get rolling. Baseball, basketball, NASCAR. There's all kinds of things you could be doing with these guys. Action247.com. When you go in there, get signed up, enter the promo code ACTION100, and they will match 100% of your deposit up to $100. So get that done now. Action247.com. These are the guys I use, and you should too. Must be 21 years or older, present in Tennessee to bet. For problem support, call the Tennessee Red Line at 1-800-889-9789.
It's Ramon Foster, and guys, I got something special for you today, okay? If you've noticed a lack of energy, motivation, and drive, it could be low T or something else, like sleep apnea or even low thyroid. Schedule a complete health assessment at Low T Center. Now they offer a monitor self-inject at-home testosterone treatment for $135 a month, self-pay or covered by most health insurance. So if you've been feeling tired, grumpy, have weight gain and loss of muscle, go to lowtcenter.com to book your appointment. Low T Center, reinventing men's healthcare.
Uncle Bud's is still catering with five trucks rolling every day that can still handle small to large catering orders. Not comfortable going out? Then bring them in. Whether it's an all-you-can-eat buffet or individual boxed meals to go, Uncle Bud's is following all current guidelines to keep you fed and moving forward. With customized menus to everything being provided, from napkins to cups, Uncle Bud's takes the stress from catering. To book, call 615-557-5757 or go to UncleBuds.com to request a catering order. Uncle Bud's, let us come see you.
Mike Keith here. Most people in Nashville know Gary Ashton as the don't sell without the intel and guaranteed offer guy. What you probably don't know is that despite his accent, Gary's also 100% guaranteed Nashville. He's a guaranteed musician, a guaranteed dog lover, a guaranteed community leader, and you're guaranteed to see Gary at every Tennessee Titans game. Guaranteed offer means you can sell your house for top dollar with no cleanings or showings and give yourself up to 90 days to close, so there's plenty of time to find your next home. Guaranteed Nashville means Gary's team lives here and loves it here. They've served Nashville for over 20 years, and they're passionate about helping our community. If you're thinking about a guaranteed offer, get the only one that's guaranteed Nashville from the Gary Ashton team with RE/MAX Advantage. To request a no-obligation offer, call 615-301-1650 or go to GaryAshton.com today. Remember, Gary Ashton, guaranteed Nashville.
The headlines have hit the news, claiming shortages of vehicles in Middle Tennessee. Not at Music City Autoplex. Their exceptional wholesale buying ability has allowed them to increase inventory to meet your needs like no other dealership. More late model, low mileage choices, more financing options, more SUVs, more trucks, more sedans. So visit Music City Autoplex today and find more of what you want in a vehicle purchase experience. See why Music City Autoplex is growing and why they are the uncommon dealership. Located at 2430 Gallatin Pike or online at musiccityautoplex.com.
You've waited 2 years for it, but the wait is almost over. Genesis Diamonds Storewide Spring Extravaganza is next weekend, April 23rd through 25th. This is the big one. A storewide sale unlike any other. Extra savings up to 35% off their already guaranteed best prices on virtually everything. Rings, earrings, bracelets, pendants, colored gemstones, even GIA certified diamonds are on sale. Don't miss it. Best prices and special financing too. 3 days only, April 23rd through 25th. Only at Genesis Diamonds. Green Hills and Cool Springs.
The Lee Company is making it easier than ever to replace your heating and air conditioning system. Special finance plans available or $1,250 off select systems. Call 615-567-1000. Online at leecompany.com/promotions.
Are you in need of organization in your home? Maybe the clutter. You want it all to have its place. I needed that. I needed it in my garage, and I got it. Thanks to my friends at Artisan Custom Closets. Not only is my garage now functional, but it's beautiful. Everything has a place. All of my neighbors walk by and say, I need that. It took less than a day to install. They worked with me to make sure it was all in my budget, and they worked with me so that everything that I had in my garage that I needed to store had its perfect place. Now, maybe it's your closet that needs a little love, or it's your pantry or your mudroom, maybe your home office. You name it, Artisan Custom Closets can do it. Give them a call. 615-800-2199 is the number. You can visit them at artisancustomclosets.com. They'll give you a free in-home consultation. Danielle will come out, see what you need. artisancustomclosets.com. Give them a call at 615-800-2199.
At Mark Spain Real Estate, we've earned more than 4,000 five-star reviews. In fact, we're the number one most reviewed real estate company in America, so you can bank on our trustworthiness like so many others have. Hi, this is Mark Spain, and if you're wondering how we have so many five-star reviews, our offers are the strongest in the industry. With the market being so hot today, we are making the absolute best and strongest offers in the history of our company. So if you need to sell your home fast, give us a call today. With the guaranteed offer from Mark Spain Real Estate, you can skip the stress. Don't worry about the hassle of constant cleaning and home maintenance. If you need to sell your home, we can help you today. You can receive an all-cash offer and close in as little as 21 days. Choose when you want to move and close with confidence. No showings, no open houses, no stress. It's that simple. Go to markspain.com/guaranteed offer. That's markspain.com/guaranteed offer and start packing.
855-299-SOLD.
Certain restrictions apply.
If you're suffering with back pain, the Disc Center of Franklin is there to give you the relief you need. Hey, it's Mickey Ryan. The next 25 callers get an exam, x-rays, a complete review of findings, and first treatment for just $35. Call the Disc Center of Franklin now, 615-551-9224.
From the 104.5 The Zone Traffic Center.
Brought to you by Smart Mouth, the only 24-hour mouthwash with twice daily use. Stay fresh out there with Smart Mouth Mouthwash, the only mouthwash that provides 24 hours of fresh breath with twice daily use. So whatever the day may bring, you can stay sunny with a side of fresh. Grab a bottle today, available wherever mouthwash is sold, or visit smartmouth.com. Crews are clearing up some debris down in Franklin. It's reduced down to one lane at I-65 southbound at Murfreesboro Road. Be on the lookout for that. And also, we have a stalled vehicle southeast of town blocking the right shoulder at I-24 eastbound right before you get to Bell Road. McGavick Pike at Riley Parkway, we also have a crash, as well as at Gallatin Pike at Hickory Street. I'm Joshua Clay with traffic on your home for Titans football. 104.5 The Zone.
There's your music. What are you doing over there? Are you coming behind me? Oh, I gotta pull it up. We got this delay. Slade's doing the Macarena.
I am not trying to do
that. Brent Doherty, Ron Slay, Will Bowling weighing in. Moe Foster talking trash all over our Twitter feed.
They can't have me, so they all come and dance.
Are you turning the camera?
Move with me, chant with me, and if you're good, I'll take you home with me.
All right, no, we've had enough of this. Thank you, guys. By the way, By the way, Dawn, she's not here. This is why it's
right.
Kind of completely lost. Lost. This looks like
that was a great view right there.
On the video,
yeah, I just saw it.
It looks like you're like we brought Tupac back to life with like some kind of weird hologram. You look like a hologram sleigh.
It did.
And then Coach Mack.
I was Coach Mack. Coach Mack was watching me.
Coach Mack's in the background. This is crazy.
I can hear him now.
All right, John Fulkerson is coming back. We've been telling you for a while that we kept hearing that he was. Just didn't want to leave on those terms, man.
Yep.
Getting that elbow, catching that elbow in the Florida game. Yep. What elbow a dirty, dirty play, too,
oh,
man.
Oh, my gosh. That's not the way.
That guy ended up in the transfer portal, too.
Yes, he did. Yes, he did.
What's his name? Payne?
Payne. That's all I remember. I wish Fulker could get another go at him. I wish he didn't transfer.
Well, when he goes to George Washington or something.
Right. Catch him in the preseason.
UAB.
He's in Illinois.
Game. Oh, Illinois. There you go.
Eastern Illinois?
No, Illinois.
Oh, he went to Illinois.
Yes.
Oh, wow.
Why did you just assume that he went directional school?
I don't know. Northland.
I mean, he was like a three-point-per-game guy that just came in to elbow Fulke. Yeah. I mean.
Exactly.
Yeah. Florida's had a lot of guys leave, but he's Illinois.
Okay.
Man.
Well, Fulkerson's coming back, and I still haven't. I'm falling down on my promises to the people.
What did you do now? You got me to do the Macarena. What else do they want?
I'm kind of getting distracted by all the trash talk going on all of our feeds. Like now that Will has us on television, that we've got Hammer Time by Ron Slay. That's a message from Facebook watching the video feed. Ron said, I'll do any dance you want because I'm a dancing machine.
That's right. And I'm comfortable in my skin.
I'm a dance.
That was in my head.
Watch me get down.
While I'm doing my thing on the video screen. Come on, Hammer. Go, Hammer. Come on, Hammer.
If you missed it earlier, me and Ron both are we have the same first concert.
Yep.
MC Hammer at Starwood.
Yep.
With Michelle A and a bunch of who else was there?
I want to say Oaktown 357 was there.
Oaktown 357 was there. 357, get loose.
Yeah. Get loose now. Yep.
We got loose. You were in biker shorts. I was
biker
not.
Shorts, yep.
I don't remember what I was wearing.
I was
probably
phenomenal.
Like cargo khaki shorts.
Two total different ends of the spectrum right there.
And here we are, all these years later,
right
sitting
here,
in the same room.
Talking about it. Talking about the great time.
And
look at Ramon talking trash.
Ramon's talking trash on our feed. You need to
tell Will, don't mess up my mic.
Need to get you. This really is the sleigh ride, somebody said. It really is.
It is. We're
all right, so Fulke coming back. So, I mean, check out that lineup, though.
Yeah.
Tennessee basketball had a big last couple of days.
Yes, it did. Yes, it did.
And what are they up to, number two in America
mm-hmm.
in recruiting?
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
It's been quite a week.
That's big time. They reloaded. And leaving at the end of the season, we knew it was going to be some roster turnover. Didn't expect all of the coaches to – take off. Dez Oliver taking a new job. You know, that, and what was that? ETSU. Him taking that job, that's now almost a springboard program for UT coaches. You had Coach Forbes take the job. Coach Shea took the job after him.
Yeah, stuff happened.
Yeah, that was wild.
Which opened it up this time.
Yeah. Dez Oliver takes the job.
I mean, Bruce Pearl's had some guys. Barnes has had some guys now. So, with regard to the Titans, the NFL draft is less than 2 weeks away.
Two weeks from now,
we will already know what the first round deal was.
And right now, Brent, who are they taking?
I want Kadarius Toney at number 22.
I'm right there with you.
You've been talking about him. You love,
yep.
as I do too, the tight end from Florida.
Well, Kyle Pitts. Oh, yeah.
So I was just kidding one day, but had some fun with it. Would you get, like I said, I would give up my entire draft pick to go up to four to get Kyle Pitts. The reason why the Titans can't do that is because they do need some bodies at some positions.
Right.
But all things being equal, that's how much I love that dude.
Yeah, me too. You know, I got man crush on him.
Seven-foot wingspan.
Dude, amazing.
Should he have played basketball?
Could have. Probably did. And probably in – His career took off so fast at Florida, he probably had to leave it alone. Like, I could easily see him on the basketball court having an impact. Like, the dude changed the direction, his hands, his feet. Like, he's serious and a competitor, man. He's a competitor. So, but as far as Toney goes, I'm definitely with him. Anytime you can get a guy that can bring multiple things to the team as he can for the Titans as far as getting a return guy, getting a guy to play receiver, a guy that can go in motion and take the handoff. Like, Tony can bring a lot of things to this team that can keep defenses off balance. So that's why I expect them to take. I would hope they do.
At Ron Slay 35, at Brent Doherty, at Will Bowling. He's sitting in here doing whatever it is he's doing.
William?
He's probably watching soccer. I don't know. He's in his computer. Braves won, though, so Will's happy. Let's go to the phones. Trash Talk Friday, and we are all in on this. We've kind of been throwing some trash around, just kind of throwing it out the windows we drive by. I mean, there hasn't been, like, one massive dump of trash.
Right. We're just going.
But there's been some I think you have some coming. Trash Talk Friday brought to you by the Disc Center of Franklin. You don't have to live with back pain. Call the Disc Center of Franklin today, 615-551-9224. Kevin, let's get line one. Bama JC in here on 3HL. I hope the phones work. Bama JC.
Daddy is. Hey, how you doing, Bama JC? Good, brother. Talk to us. Nobody's really on the line. I tricked both of you guys.
Y'all ought to see Will and Brent.
Y'all ought to see Will and Brent looking at me like,
so confused.
Dude, what is he saying?
Like, oh, my God.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
I'm like, is Ron hearing voices again? I looked at Will like,
incredible.
Will and I couldn't hear anything. Ron's acting like he's talking to the biggest Bama fan that ever walked. Wow.
That's like incredible.
That? There you go. Yeah, you're welcome. You're all welcome, people. Acting skills right there. I was in Macbeth. No, straight up.
Let's dive into this. Who needs phones?
Y'all know that.
Fix the phones whenever you want. We can just start talking about Ron Slay's acting career.
I was in Macbeth.
And I wait. Bama JC.
Yeah.
JC.
Okay.
JC, are you there?
Yeah.
All right, little John.
Right.
Bama JC.
I tell you what, man. Kevin, I wish you guys could have seen me in Macbeth.
Kevin, you might want to put him on hold or something's going to happen.
Yeah, because this story about Macbeth is way more important than what Bama JC is about to talk about. I can promise you that.
What role did you play in Macbeth?
I forgot. But
remember so specifically that you were in Macbeth. Though.
Yeah, I do. Then the only reason I can't remember, let me tell y'all this, I had to memorize my lines too, y'all. It wasn't no run off the side of the stage, see what you got to say and come back. Had to memorize my lines as a senior at Oak Hill Academy. I was getting involved in anything that I could to get away from the dorm.
I thought all y'all did was play sports at Oak Hill.
Right. That's what you would think until the spring arrives and basketball season is over.
Next thing you know, you're in Macbeth memorizing
lines. I was
lines.
In the equestrian club on the what? Baseball team. I was
baseball team?
Yeah, I was in drama. And the funny thing, I can't tell that one on air.
I made it through it.
Oh, Kevin says, let's try it again. Bama JC.
Right, here we go.
You there?
Hey, guess what? that's cool, but before you say anything, Bama JC, let me say this. Now, your trash talk, it better be A1. So, ready? Go. Hey, boy, you crazy. Hey. Anyway, Macbeth. So I was slick fried when I was doing Macbeth.
Slick Rick. Slick fried meaning what?
Means fried. We all know what fried. If you know me, you know what fried means. I've heard you figure it out.
I've heard you use it for.
Yeah, I got different. I'm fried.
You had some alcohol or?
Yes, I did.
It was a puff night puff
before.
Give moment.
Nah, this was alcohol.
Okay.
It was before I was supposed to go on. I took a shot to sober back up and the shot made me a little bit more tipsy.
You took a shot to sober.
I heard when you have a hangover, you're supposed to drink again.
Okay, all right.
You know what I mean? So I took another. Yeah, and I was like, whoa, wait a minute.
I'm tracking now.
And I got it all right, though. I got it all right. That was one of the greatest stage performances.
The lights came on and.
And Big Slay showed up.
Showtime.
Yep.
So what happened? What was your line? Do you remember?
Nope.
I was
one of the main characters. I might have been Macbeth.
being in theater.
Do you remember if you were Macbeth?
It was 1999.
Great Prince.
Being in theater in high school is the number one thing Ron Slay and I have in common now.
See? There you go, Will.
That and being Tennessee athletes.
Hey, man, listen, I'm a jack of all trades, man. I've Ubered. I've been in drama. I've been in an equestrian club. I've drove trucks.
I would love to see Ron Slay in equestrian club.
I was phenomenal.
Wait, you were an Uber driver?
Yeah, when I first came back.
It's so want to ride in your car.
It was
we need a
party.
Camera in the room.
It was a party. It was a party.
You could hop on Ron Slay's horse since he was in equestrian club.
I was in the equestrian
club. What did you do in the equestrian club?
Cleaned stalls and took the horses out to ride. I took the horses. Don't just write me off like that. I took the horses out to ride. Me and Muhammad El Sagir, my Egyptian homeboy. Yeah, I like that. See, I'm telling y'all the truth, man.
I have a headache. Like,
I'm telling y'all the truth.
I don't know what to do with any of this.
JC keeps trying to jump into my line. JC, get out of my line when I'm telling my stories about Equestrian Club. You feel me?
It sounds like somebody's like just has the radio on and is listening to us. Yeah, and
somebody's hacked
us.
Somebody's
we tried to go to JC like six times.
Maybe it's Macbeth.
Where do I place my anger? At the phone system not working or at the caller not having awareness?
Or where do I place mine?
Balls to the wall. Did Ron Slay just say he was on the equestrian team?
Yes, people.
Ron Slay's been horsing around since 99.
Hey, and guess what? I'm going to tell you.
Will Bowen has the best dad jokes ever. And he's 23 years old and very far from
listen, I didn't have friends in high school because all I said was dad jokes in middle school and high school.
I believe you.
And my friends in high school can confirm that.
I'm going to tell y'all what. I wish I could add Tim Henry, who was my teacher at Oak Hill Academy. And Mr. Henry will confirm this story. Ron was on the equestrian club. I wish I could find a yearbook. If I could find a yearbook, you'll see a tall sleigh with khakis on and Nike boots.
I love it.
Blue polo.
I learned something new about Ron Slay every single time we do
with
this.
A small
Your mom calls like, hey, Ron, what'd you do today? Oh, Mom, I cleaned out the stall and I took the horse out.
Yeah.
Played baseball, and then I was Macbeth or one of the other characters.
Only
I don't know.
One, dude. Yeah.
What position did you play in baseball?
Now, let me tell you how this went. So, we had tryouts in the gym because it was raining. I'm good at fielding. So, I told him, you can put me I nicknamed myself Air Traffic Control. So, I wanted to be somewhere in the outfield, you know, and so I was great at fielding. When it came time, and I made the team, Mr. Larson was the coach. When I made the team, you also had to go hit.
Well, yeah.
I wasn't cool with standing right there with that ball coming that fast. So I made the team and I quit.
Because you didn't want to hit.
I didn't want that ball coming that fast at me.
What happened to the competitor?
Yeah, that was a little scary right there. All it needed ball just to crack me upside the head one time, and that'll do it for me.
Well, you got a helmet on.
Bama JC has commented on Facebook saying, I'm done with y'all.
Bama JC, first of all, we love you.
And then two words that start with an R and T that I'm not going to say.
Oh, no, don't you dare. No.
Justin on Periscope says, this is probably one of the best 3HLs ever. It's like the reindeer have ran from the sleigh. but the sleigh is right here. It's like the sleigh is running away from the reindeer.
And if the reindeer get away, sleigh will turn around and go chase the reindeer.
Does that make Don Davenport Santa in this analogy?
I don't know.
If the reindeer are running
Don
away.
Is so glad she's not sitting
she's
in this room right now.
Oh, yeah, she's standing up. This too
Brent says Ron Sleigh is just a badass.
Yeah, there we go. Give me some love.
All right. We'll try to wrap this thing when we come back.
Jerry on Facebook.
I played
you guys
soccer.
Awesome.
I played soccer too. Hey, I was a goalie. No, I'm telling y'all the truth. I was a goalie.
Did you have the big gloves?
Yeah.
Like Mickey Mouse?
Yeah, and I took them off. I told them I don't want to use the gloves.
I played
and that was dumb because I jammed my finger. That ball was hard.
For those of you who are in the comments, I'm going to try to pull this train back on the tracks at least a little bit.
Reel us back in.
We need to take a break. That's what we need to do.
For those of you who are in the comments, we got time. Yeah, for those of you who are in the comments.
We got time. Yeah, that's right. That's what he said. He said let it fly.
This is what you want from me. I'm giving it right back to you.
Adios.
For those of you who are in the comments, if you, it's easy, exclamation notify in the Facebook comments. Anytime we go live, it's going to notify you right to your phone.
Yeah.
That way you never miss any of this. So if you comment exclamation point notify, you're going to turn on live notifications for 104.5
Oh, that's well done. Yeah.
Brent's head is hurting.
It's hurting.
I asked you earlier if your key card worked yet, and you were like, no, come let me in. Yeah. And we're all going to try to get back here on Monday, and none of our key cards going to work. We'll be right back. 3HL 104.5 The Zone.
Cough syrup and eyebrow trimming don't mix. Just ask Buck.
I was doped up on, I think, cough syrup, and I accidentally shaved off my eyebrows. It was definitely noticeable for about a week.
Buck Rising, Monday, 10 a.m. to 1 p.m. on 104.5 The Zone.
Hey, are you looking for some cash for maybe a home improvement project? Maybe pay off some credit cards. I know it's been tough times for a lot of people, and maybe that credit card debt has climbed.
Maybe you are just looking for a lower house payment. Loan Pronto can make it happen with their zero-cost refi program. You can refinance your mortgage now. Lock in that lower payment. Get that cash out of your home's equity. Rates are still super low right now, still at historic lows. So call and see what your options are. Snag that lower rate with no lender fees, no cumbersome process. Loan Pronto's all-digital platform makes it simple. And they can cover your closing costs too, by the way. Call now, refi to that better rate, maybe get cash out. If you're a veteran too, by the way, Loan Pronto specializes in VA loans with super fast turnaround, crazy low rates, streamlined process. The phone number, 615-499-5780, loanpronto.com. Equal housing lender, NMLS 1661781, subject to lender approval, not available on all loans.
If you measure your lawn by the acre, mow it with the number one selling diesel zero-turn mower series. With comfort, with durability, with the Kubota ZD. ACS deck technology for improved cutting performance, responsive and durable shaft drive transmissions, and hands-free hydraulic deck lift. No matter how you measure your lawn, the Kubota ZD delivers. Visit your local Kubota dealer today. Go to KubotaUSA.com for full disclaimer.
Coleman Tractor, working hard to keep you working. Now with four locations, Nashville, Paris, Clarksville, and White House, Tennessee.
For the first time in two decades, the world of outlaws and dirt car racing invades Bristol Motor Speedway. April 8th to the 10th, it's the world of outlaws, Morton Buildings Late Models, and the Dirt Car Modifieds in the Bristol Bash. Then April 22nd to 24th, the world of outlaws, NOS Energy Drink Sprint Cars, together with Super Dirt Car Series Big Block Modifieds in the Bristol Throwdown. Tickets and camping now at BristolMotorSpeedway.com. Bristol Bash and Bristol Throwdown this April. You don't want to miss it because
it's Bristol, baby!
A reading from the Golden Oak Lending Book of Mortgage Lingo. What is Zipline? It's Golden Oak's fast and easy online mortgage tool that leaves you with more time to plan a family movie night.
I get to pick the movie!
And clean up the popcorn you weren't planning on sharing. At Golden Oak Lending, we speak mortgage and love translating it. Right now, rates are at a record low 1.875%. Visit goldenoaklending.com to use Zipline. NMLS 114937. 1.875% fixed. 2.913% APR. FHA 15-year mortgage with 20% equity and approved credit.
After two long years, Genesis Diamond's Spectacular Spring Extravaganza is back. April 23rd through 25th. Three incredible days. Storewide savings. Up to 35% off Genesis already guaranteed best price on engagement rings, earrings, bracelets, wedding bands, plus special financing. This is the big one. The one where they break all the rules. Even Genesis GIA certified diamonds are marked down. Plus top jewelry designers are flying in their entire collections. You've waited long enough. So don't miss this. April 23rd through 25th at Genesis Diamond. Green Hills and Cool Springs. Unapproved credit.
You've waited 2 years for it, but the wait is almost over. Genesis Diamond's store-wide spring extravaganza is next weekend, April 23rd through 25th. This is the big one. A store-wide sale unlike any other. Extra savings up to 35% off. They're already guaranteed best prices on virtually everything. Rings, earrings, bracelets, pendants, colored gemstones, even GIA-certified diamonds are on sale. Don't miss it. Best prices and special financing, too. 3 days only, April 23rd through 25th. Only at Genesis Diamond's. Green Hills and Cool Springs.
It's red.
With heated seats.
Serious air conditioning.
And that little compartment thingy, you know, where you put your sunglasses.
You found the perfect car. Now get the perfect loan with Ascend. We've got low rates, flexible terms, and you can apply online at ascend.org or at any of our branch locations.
I'm going to name her Betty.
Auto loans from Ascend Federal Credit Union. Banking without the bank. Ascend is federally insured by NCUA. All loans are subject to credit approval.
We all know that Mr. Goodroof is your favorite roofing company, but did you know that Mr. Goodroof also does windows? Mr. Goodroof offers a variety of replacement windows to choose from that are guaranteed to satisfy your design taste or maybe your significant other's picky design taste, and they'll save you money on your heat and air bill too. From roofs, windows, to gutters, even siding, Mr. Goodroof has you covered. Now, let's also talk about your roof. When was the last time you were up there? You know what kind of shape it's in, do you? What if you need a repair or even a replacement? What if you got storm damage? Don't trust one of the door knockers. Call Mr. Goodroof, a locally owned family business that Middle Tennesseans have trusted for years. Mr. Goodroof is licensed and insured, and they always have a supervisor on site in case you have questions. Visit Mr. Goodroof's showroom in Hendersonville or call him at 615-824-8100.
The Lee Company is making it easier than ever to replace your heating and air conditioning system.
special finance plans available or $1,250 off select systems. Call 615-567-1000. Online at leecompany.com/promotions.
If you're suffering with back pain, the Disc Center of Franklin is there to give you the relief you need. Hey, it's Mickey Ryan. The next 25 callers get an exam, x-rays, a complete review of findings, and first treatment for just $35. Call the Disc Center of Franklin now, 615-551-9224.
From the 104.5 The Zone Traffic Center.
Have a few new accidents in East Nashville at 5th Street at Woodland Street and another at Dickerson Pike at Trinity Lane. We still have a stalled vehicle blocking the right shoulder southeast of town at I-24 eastbound right before you get to Bell Road, and crews clearing up some debris on the roadway still down in Franklin at I-65 southbound at Murfreesboro Road. Traffic is reduced down to two lanes through there. Also by Belmont at Blair Boulevard at 21st Avenue dealing with an accident in that direction. I'm Joshua Clay with traffic on your home for Titans football, 104.5 The Zone.
Touch this. You can't touch this.
Ron's taking a dance request, so I don't know what's happened so far. Carlton, he's on the phone now. Ron's phone works. He was going to do the Chinese typewriter, the MC Hammer dance. You can look that up on Google. Chris says, we need to have a Ron Slay versus Kirby, what all they have done in their lives showdown.
That's a terrific idea.
I mean, Ron hit us with, he was in Macbeth at Oak Hill. What are you talking about?
I have some
Ron's on speakerphone. It wasn't Macbeth. It wasn't Macbeth. it was the importance of being earnest. I don't even know what that is. Oh, man. All right. Trash Talk Friday going on.
On the air, we called.
You are on the air.
Ron is just having a full phone conversation, and we're just sitting here doing the radio.
Shoot your shot. That's coming up. Right now, you give us the lock of the weekend. Shoot Your Shot, presented by Daddy Rack Tennessee Straight Whiskey. Daddy Rack Tennessee Straight Whiskey, try some today.
I told him.
You told what? Who?
I was wrong, though. Steph,
It's important for you to be able to admit when you're wrong.
And that's what I'm doing.
Okay.
I just called Coach Smith's wife, Lisa Smith, who was like a team mom to us. And we do
at Oak Hill?
Yeah, we don't make it at Oak Hill without Coach Smith's wife. I promise, without the cooking and everything. She's just confirmed. It wasn't Macbeth, so I apologize, everybody. It was the importance of being earnest. Same time frame.
I don't even think that's the title.
I think it is. She said it. She just remembered. She said, and I had to wear an old outfit and the pants were tight. That was the funny thing of it. She said, I just went home or somewhere, but I went off campus, and she said, I got back 5 minutes before. 5 minutes before the show was supposed to start. And the reason I never told her this, but I was fried. That's why I got 5 minutes before. So,
hey, you can see your comments on the screen now, too, by the way. That's what I've been working on. If you noticed, I wasn't at my seat during the break. On our video stream right now, if you comment, it's going to pop up right underneath Brent Doherty and right beside me.
See? And Coach Smith's daughter, Steph, who's like my little sister, who was there, she was 1 year younger than me. She just said, are you on the radio right now? Oh my gosh, I do remember that. I even feel like a picture exists somewhere. Steph, if you get that picture, that'd be beautiful.
We need that.
That'd be beautiful.
The importance of being earnest, yes.
I told true. You.
Yes.
Come on, Brent, man. Come yeah. on now.
But what character did
the
you
lack
play?
Of
I was
faith.
The main, whatever the main character was. Who was the main guy character?
Right. You were the lead?
I don't know.
Yes.
It's probably,
were you earnest?
It was probably earnest.
The importance of being earnest.
I'm earnest.
Earnestly.
I'm earnest. But guess, look, see, I'm telling you, all the God. People are saying they remember it. See, okay. All the important people.
Cousin yeah. Caden said, simple fix of the phones. Just give Ron Slay's cell phone number out and go speaker.
I feel bad that we've rewarded the phones being off when they have with this great content. But you know what? This is what we do.
Kevin, do we still have Caleb? Is Caleb still floating out there somewhere? No, he's gone. Okay.
Hey, right. man, I love this show, man.
Oh, my shot. Preds are taking down Carolina. Ooh. I don't care that they haven't beaten them this year. It's happening on Saturday. Will can wait and see who the goaltenders are. But it doesn't matter who the goaltenders are.
Don't even matter.
It don't matter. The Preds are taking down Carolina. They're not losing two in a row to those jokers.
I'm jumping on board with you, and I'm betting. Action 24/7. I'm betting. How about that?
All right, what's your shot?
I'm taking my shot, and my shot is Vandy boys going down up on Rocket Top, baby. The Vols go knocking on the door.
Are they going to lock the door and get that sweep?
I know y'all want me to jump out there, and I jump out there a lot, but it's a lot of times I got to be in reality. So I think they just win one. But I think they win tomorrow.
So Vandy takes the series 2 out of 3, but yep. Tennessee wins tomorrow.
Yep.
Against Jack Leiter.
I'm going to be honest. We are all the marbles on the table. We are. I don't care. I'm just like Brent. I don't care who the goalie is. None of that means anything.
All right.
Matter of fact, respect. I'm out there. Vols sweep them. Let's get it on over with. Let's get it over with. Vols sweep them.
I just shot Pellegrino all over the studio.
Vols sweep them. I'm done with it. And I'm done with it. That's it. Earnest.
They're not beating Leiter.
For all of your college baseball expertise.
We're going to it then.
Honestly,
Brett.
That would be the one they win. Just watch.
Okay.
I ain't no just watch. I'm telling y'all people now.
Oh, he's saying
you can
just watch.
Yeah, you can I'm watch. You can watch me tell
saying,
you
no,
guys.
Just watch.
Yeah, no, I'm telling you right now. It is what it is.
Zena says, you guys are killing me. Jerry says, no way in hell Tennessee will be the, and it stops there. Hal says, this is great. So what's your shot?
My shot?
Nashville SC scores more than 0 goals.
Well, yeah. I mean, that's... It's not even debatable. Braves are sweeping the Cubs. Sure.
Hey.
Braves win 4,
uh-oh,
lose 4.
Give me Hammer.
They lose 4 again. Hammer. Now they're going to win 4 again.
He already gave you Hammer, but you were on the phone with Mrs. Smith.
Oh, darn. Bring it back. Bring Hammer back.
There you go.
Okay, Ron Slay. If you're not on the video we've got to be able to explain this. Ron Slay is uncomfortably close to me, behind me.
You look so scared.
Doing the typewriter. I can see the reflection.
This is going to be recorded. This will be one of the gifts that Ron Slay is putting on Twitter every time he's on the show very soon.
Why are you out of breath?
That was a lot.
That was a lot.
I was on my toes. I was on my toes and not on the ball of my
feet. Sound like you're fried again,
right,
Ron Slay.
So, Preds are beating Carolina. Tennessee sweeping Vandy. The Braves are sweeping the Cubs. We got to go, Kevin says. This is the craziest 3HL show ever. And that's saying something.
Lock the door. How about?
One of the hottest pro sports teams can be found right here in Nashville. Your Predators. And for the best Predators coverage, it's 104.5 The Zone.
This is Tiki Barber with a CBS Sports Minute, sponsored by NetSuite by Oracle. Receive your free product tour right now.